Okay, good morning. We are live. Hi, Steve. Welcome to the show. Howdy. Welcome. Here we are once again. Oh, there's my guitar chord just sneaking around there, playing around. I was playing guitar yesterday. Always fun to do. Relaxing. I do have this kind of dermatitis, kind of, you know, the ends of my fingers get a little chapped and stuff. And so that makes it difficult. This is something that's an autoimmune thing you get, you know. I guess it was too much Cheerios growing up or something. Although I was one of those kids that my mom and dad, especially my dad, you know, there was no fun cereal like, hey, I want Fruit Loops. No, you're going to have puffed wheat or porridge, you know, Red River cereal. Yeah. Anybody remember that? Hello, can you hear me? Yes, Sava, we hear you well. So anyway, it's Monday. We've had snow. The last few days, my mommy's coming back. This is my birth mother. It was one of these kids that got adopted out. I was just a little thing. I was like 2 weeks old and stuff. I was just a baby and whatnot. Sarah's here. Now, Sarah, are we going to be able to get your presence on camera today? Or is this a working day? I think it's a working day. I don't think we can get her. But anyway, if you're available later, you're always welcome. You make the show better. By your grace, your charm, your je ne sais quoi. Okay, so we got a lot of vinyl community happenings going on. Anyway, my mom's going to be here about 11 o'clock my time. So I say, Rachel was a baby once. Yeah, there's video of it and everything. Michael Mikret is in with his wrench, which is good to see. Brad Teal's on board. Everybody's coming in. This is a good thing. We love seeing you folks because really the secret of the success, if any can be measured, is by your participation. Without the audience, we got nothing. Got nothing, Jerry. And because, you know, you can't be shouting into a vacuum. That's no fun. Matt Basterson. Again, Matt, as always, thanks for your generosity, your kindness, and all your support, I guess, is what I want to say. You're top tier. You're wonderful. Folks, I want to shout out again, Nick Tronic. I know he gets a little shy about it. He gets a little, oh, it's nothing. But he's got a Bandcamp page. And he really is a guy. Like, he's doing music. And he's got his own merch store now. And I just love to see everybody support him. I'm trying to get him up on the show more often so that, you know, we can promote him, right? Anyway, let me see if I can pull in the actual address for him. Nick Tronic, artist. Yes, he's an artist, for the love of God. And he's got a new one out right now, new album. Well, not a new album, new song, right? He released a new song. I got him on my notification bar, so anytime he does new music, I can be notified of it. He doesn't have physical media. It's just for downloading stuff. Okay, now, this is bad news. My daughter was hospitalized Thursday, and we're finally getting settled in the other day, so I probably won't jump on. I fully understand. I'm so sorry, Sarah, that your dear daughter has suffered a medical setback. So, you know, we wish her good things. Hopefully everything's okay. Oh, boy. You know, because we love our children, you know. Boy, oh, boy. I got one. Sue and I made one together. It's John. We don't see him enough. But now he's a couple hours away from us, so, you know, there's traveling and the rest. Dave, welcome back to the show. Always good to see you. Dave went AWOL for a week. His computer crapped out on him. I forgot to hear back from you. Did that cost you a pretty penny, or was it okay? I'm off work today. It's Casimir Pulaski Day here in the States. What's Casimir Pulaski, Michael? You got to teach me about that. Casimir Pulaski. I have no idea about that. I'm listening to you to feel normal today. Yeah. Get back in the swing of things. Okay. She's all better now. Just lots of big changes for her. All right. Well, we want her to be well, strong, healthy, strengthened, and good in her heart, you know, so that her emotions and peace of mind and all that's part and parcel of her packaging. Dave was gone for almost 2 weeks, Rach. Wow. That's just crazy, you know. That is crazy. Best wishes for Raging Tomato and her family. He was gone exactly 11 days. Brad, I had no idea you were following Dave's career so closely, but I appreciate that. The arrangement, good to hear your daughter is okay. This is from Dave. So that is just wonderful. Now, what else is happening? Contests, a lot of contests. Sam St. John is being championed by Steve. All the World's a Stage. This is a contest going right now over at this channel. It's called All the World's a Stage. Your host is Steve. He's a super nice guy. And you got to show why Sam St. John is a one-trick pony, which this seems horrible, but, you know, that's what it is. Oh, by the way, I got a treat for you. Is it a treat? So, speaking of music and light, Malachi's song, I was able to get a hold of the MP4 on that thing and download it, so I'm able to present it for you. Here's what the AI created, kind of a theme song for this show. If anybody's good with graphics, Marius Stark, Davy Strange name, get to work. Okay, share screen. No, video file. I'm going to present it for you now. Casimir Pulaski helped us during the Revolutionary War. Michael, that's wonderful. My ninth great-grandfather fought in the American Revolution. I think he was my ninth, maybe eighth. Anyway, one of my great-greats fought there. In fact, two of my great-greats fought in the big one there against, all enemies, foreign, domestic. Okay, so what the hell was it? Okay. I guess last month. Okay, music, down videos. Wow, where did I drop this baby? I got it on my computer somewhere. Anyway, I thought I just dropped it in downloads. Yeah. Anyway, my movie, Small, February 5th. That's way back, man. History, where's the history in this thing? No. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'll find it later in the show when we have more people. The 106 is being called for. 106. People love the 106. Okay, well, if you want it, well, okay, what the hell? Let's do it. I'll give you 106. Again, it's the same situation. I've got it on the thing. Video file. Do you want the rock version or do you want the OG? To get Marvin back, a hostage situation? None of you. And Marvin's his own man. You know, he's got his own path to walk. I can't answer that. Here's Rene Rock. Let's do Rock. You know, you want Savo wants the OG? OG? All right. So this would be here. This would be all files. And it's called Renee. Here we go.
Like I said, it's
Hello, can you hear me?
Holy smokes. Well, you know, it's got to be the hit of the season, this thing, this 106. Really capturing the hearts and minds of the children all over the world. That is just crazy. Crazy, crazy stuff. Okay, there's the thing. I wonder if I could just drop that here on my desktop. There it is. All right. Okay, this is like a lot of music going on here. It never gets old. I love this so much. John Fields is more like torture. Michael just goes, wow. It could be, the jury could be out on this big hit by Renee. Okay, and also YP did all the work on that. But I guess there's, have you heard about this AI thing? AI can do songs. So Malachi, we had a decent Malachi in yesterday. Malachi had a song for me, and I've been able to get it. It gets old, all right. It gets old. Okay, I know. I'm so sorry. Here's a new song created by a computer, and we'll just have to see how it goes. Now, how do I get, there's my desktop, and all files. Okay, here we go. This is the new song. It's just an audio thing, I think. Okay. Oh, it doesn't have a video track. Well, that's okay. I don't want to. Does it have to have a video track? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Well, it's not kidding me. Anyway, okay, so I'll have to put some graphics to the damn thing. Good Lord. You know, I try and run a show. Is Malachi is on the vocals? I don't think so. I mean, is it really? That's him singing it? Well, he does good if it's him. They're already banning 106 and Guitar Centers. Kids come in all excited. Can I play 106? Hey, what's happening, Eric? Welcome to the show. Hey, great news for neocons and Democrats. Haley Mills won the primary run in District of Columbia, D.C., the capital, you know. And we're so proud of this little fighter. She's scrappy, right? She's working hard to become president. Exciting. And so she won all the delegates, and she's incredible. And quite a bit of a looker, if you ask me, and I know you do. I tested a program Malachi used yesterday. It's all AI, but you can type in the lyrics and also slightly remix it. It's a fun page. We'll drop a link so we can do more stuff. I've got to write a song for Sam St. John. Maybe I'll give him the lyrics, and then I'll let the AI do it. If you got a link for that, Seb, give it to me. Let me have it. Boom. I know you can do that. Isn't Malachi where they keep the people? Malachi is a book in the Old Testament. It's one of the minor prophets, what's called one of the minor prophets. Woot is here. Hello from Florida and the U.S. Folks, if you're interested in UFOs and that kind of thing, this is where you want to go. This is the Woot and the Pooged Goo. Hello from Florida, USA. Okay, here's the thing. It's called that. All right, I guess I got to watch my own show so I can access it. I'm going. Okay, good. Let's take a look. Okay, I'm going to leave that thing open because I need to. So it's called Sunu. Okay, create. Okay, create your account. Okay, I'll have to create an account. I'll do that later in the show. I'll just leave that open for now. Okay, so anyway, I was promoting our good friend Nicktronic over on Bandcamp. Check him out, please. Support him over there. Okay, Rachel, go make a song on the spot for us, but you have to register with your Google account. Oh, no. They want me Google? They'll take all my information, my soul. Yeah. Rachel, would you look for me if I went missing? No, I would not. I would miss you, though, Brad. You're fun and clever, intelligent, helpful, proactive, positive. Keith Richards' version of the Velvet Underground, yeah, he did. Which song did he cover? I heard about that. We talked about a little bit about yesterday. Sean says Nicktronic has some cool music. He's a cool guy. We love him. Can AI make fake Ringo the main singer of the fake Beatles? Yeah, they could. If you're into no wave ambient avant-garde. Concrete Crowd, please check out Zeb's band. Zeb's on Bandcamp too. So many people are out there making music, which is great. I think Rachel is willing me to go missing today because I'm disrupted. No, I think you're highly respected of the monologue. Monologue's a strong part. So everybody, Neil Counts, congratulations, you had a big day. Now today, North Dakota, a couple other states are going. And then tomorrow, you know what tomorrow is, Politicos? Tomorrow is Super Tuesday. And it's looking very much like my beloved Donald John Trump is going to, you know, he's the clear winner. So that's going to happen. But at least we got a beautiful parting gifts for Haley as she departs. And with the Haley, you're a scrapper. You're a bit of a scrapper. Watching a lot of these things on the progress of the Ukraine-Russia conflict. Have anybody heard about this? And there's lots happening. Tomorrow could be Haley Mills' last day. It could very well be. It could very well be. And hopefully that is the case. I'm a little tired of seeing her. It's like, when was this? They had a caucus runoff in Idaho or something. She got zero seats at all. Now, what's so funny about that is the funny thing about Haley there, she got zero. I got the same amount of votes as Haley, which is crazy, but it's true. Haley and I equaled out on that one. Why is she still in the race? Because it's money. She's making money. She's also running interference. She's like a tiny little front linesman, and she's holding up the defense there in order to allow the Hail Mary to go. But it's not going to work for her. She's too tiny in the role. I would have put her as a safety, tiny, fast, moving around. Keith Richards got electrocuted on stage, but he lived back in 65. I just read. Well, thank God he lived, because that would have ended the Rolling Stones, maybe. Well, probably it's the Rolling Stones. They'll go on till there's no one left. Rach, it's so cute. You're still pretending Trump is a neocon. Well, by my definition of a neocon, it's those people supporting the military-industrial complex, the big money that goes in, and that are shaking hands. They're in bed with the Obamas and the Clintons. Like those pictures you get of George W. and he's sitting all cuddled up with Big Mike. Those ones, have you seen those? They're adorable. And it's just crazy. It's just crazy what goes on. So those are the neocons to me, okay? Military industrial complex and Democrat cuddlers. Okay, if you're cuddling Democrats, now admittedly, I'm a bit of a neocon because if I see Rob or Mazzy, obviously I'm going to cuddle them because they're adorable. Good morning, French Vinel Addictus Ramad. Very nice to see you. Nikki Haley is cute. Yes, absolutely. That's what, we need more. Like also Alexandria Cortez. She's fantastic. Ocasio. Rachel is a neocon. Holy smokes. Thank you, Pumping Vinyl. Well, Rachel, we predicted Trump didn't increase military spending by an ungodly amount. Well, a strong military is an important thing. You just don't use it. Walk softly, carry a big stick, okay? You don't walk loudly and carry the big stick. If you're walking loudly carrying the big stick, that means you're looking for trouble. You're whipping pin up in all the wrong places. But if you walk softly and carry a big stick, people tend to leave you alone. So strong, silent type, that's the way to go. I saw Rob yesterday. I didn't feel the need to cuddle him. Well, that's because you're all buoyed up. Okay. Double entendre. You're all buoyed up. It means like you're a guy. You don't want to cuddle. But with all my feminine instincts in play, obviously, Rob's a tall drink of water. Okay. So there is that to be considered. Now, today's program is called Vinyl Community Happenings, and there's a lot happening. There's a lot happening, Foxy. What's happening, Basil? There's a lot happening, Foxy. And one of the things that's going to be happening is we've got two contests going on. One is for our own beloved Chris Rekotok. The other is for Steve, All the World's the Stage. This is the Sam St. John Center one. Very strange contest, but I got to do something for it. And then the other thing I got to do, Mr. Ram, you. Good morning, Rachel. I've had a slight name change. Well, that's acceptable. It's very good. Ties you into Miss You. So you're a couple, and you're early on in your relationship. So I assume you two kids are nesting. It's fresh love. It's new. Rob's a 64-ouncer, Rach. Tell you that right now. Jethro Tull, kids. Voivod, Metal, Progsans. You can sub here. Over there, there's a thing to sub. I don't know what that one is. Ba Ram Woo. Yeah, isn't that from Babe Pig in the City? Ba Ram Woo. The way I see it, throwing record amounts of money at the military, one makes one part of the military. Yeah, I don't know. I don't see it that way. I think you have to. It's a necessary evil in our world. You need to have a strong military. Right now, America's military is very weak. You guys are weaker than shit. The Russians are laughing their asses at you. They've blown up already two M1 Abrams tanks. Now, the problem with that, this is a frontline tank for the United States. The problem with this is these vehicles were not meant to be thrown out to the front lines as cannon fodder, which is what they've become. So the Russians are having a big ha-ha-ha over it right now. Why are the Americans weak? The Americans are weak because military is, the reserves are not where you need in order to be a frontline fighting force. And people are flexing their muscles against you. China, Russia, a lot of people are taking advantage of the opportunity make a move on you people. We are a half step away from the draft in the USA. Well, yeah, because people just aren't signing up. They fail to, capture the imagination. I was a little kid. I'm 5 years old. I'm watching Vic Morrow. Remember him? He died tragically, 82, in the Twilight Zone movie incident with the two little Vietnamese children. The U.S. military is weak. God damn you. Drink that Russian Kool-Aid by the gallon. Yeah, you guys are weak. And the proof of it is Russia's running ramshot all over the Ukraine. And they are kicking the fucking living hell out of those guys right now. And it's horror. It's just horror. And that you can, oh my God. And I watch the Ukraine stuff. I don't watch the Russian stuff. I watch the Ukraine to see what they're saying. And because what's happening, even they are admitting, yeah, we're doing this, we're doing this. General Milley just came out, you know, that cat. He just came on. What can you do about? What can we do about? Well, you need to increase your military spending. You've cut your budget, so the budget's got to go up. The military, what's happening right now is you're sending a lot of ordnance, you're sending a lot of equipment, you're sending a lot of money over, and the stuff's just being gobbled up. The warfare has once again changed, okay? So it's all these Lancet drones. Have you been watching these strikes? The Lancets are a big thing. And the... yeah, the Russian military. Oh, I wouldn't say so. I wouldn't say that in any way, shape, or form. Rich, do you disagree with Trump on any position? Do you agree with him on everything? I disagree with him on his position with a certain medical prevention that happened a couple of years ago. And so I have some concerns about that. Vic Morrow in Combat with Little John. That was a great, great show. That's when you're a little kid. When I was a kid. Oh, and by the way, this is a guy. I love this guy. You should support Haley Mills. She loves the military complex and wars. Exactly. You're so right about that. And that's why I don't. Here goes the producer. That's why I don't support her. So what happens is that, you know, there's all this money going into everything. He never got charged with rape. Okay, Brad Teal. Okay, that's a bad word. Okay, it was a sexual violence. She tried to nail. I read the report on that. I read the report. So she claimed that he actually R-worded her. And the fact is, the jury said that did not happen. So she lied about that. She lied. And yet, because it's political, they want to throw some money at Trump anyway. We're watching this. Us MAGA people, we're watching with interest, keeping an eye on our favorite presidential nominee, Donald J. Trump. Fantastic. I'm going to be over soon around noon. Chris from Record Talk is not Topher. He's always Chris, but for a brief time, he had an awkward period. Now, Chris has got a contest. It's a leap year contest, Chris. I wanted to roll that into the actual fabric of today's show because, you know, these contest videos, they generally don't get much traction. So you're just repeating the slander that Trump got charged for. Yeah, you know, you can lay anything on anybody. Oh dear, Brad Teal attacked me. Then I take you into my area and then we F you over. It's refreshing to seeing someone defend Trump for a stage instead of throwing him under the bus like the Dems do. Well, they have to because he's a political opponent there, Beetle Babe. This is Jen. She's got a great channel. And Jen, of course, as always, you're welcome to join us later in the show today. Brad goes, let's see it happen. Well, that's the whole nature of things. And what they do, it's called the wrap-up smear. And it what it does is like goo. It's like it's like molasses. It ties you down. And then 2 years later, then the facts start coming out and you go, oh, okay, that's what went down. And so we have appeal problems. We have a lot of stuff. Jen, you love this stream last night. I think there's very few. In fact, I probably count on one hand the amount of us that support the president, but I do. But I loved you. We got way more liberal heroes than we do. We call them liberal heroes here. And I want to thank Loki Teal for that. He said, don't call it, what's the word? Don't call them lib, you know, I don't even want to say it. So hurtful to liberal heroes. And so there's a word, though, they use, right? And it's lib. But I call liberal heroes, Loki was right. I think it's sweeter. I think it's kinder. And we have so many great liberal heroes on the TV show that I love anyway. So, and you guys all put up with me, guys and gals, you all put up with me despite your political leanings. And so I'm very grateful to you for that. But yeah, things are happening. Isn't it time they monetized you again, Rachel? Yeah, I know. I know the word you mean. Yes, there's a word. Stop it, Ricardo. Ricardo, don't even type it. Don't you feel sullied? Anyway, so Chris Record's got a contest going. It involves leap years. Now, Chris, do you want one record from three different leap years, or you want three records from three different leap years? I was kind of curious about that. Beetle Babe, I got demonetized because YouTube, in their infinite wisdom, failed to explain what they were all about when they introduced the shorts. Because we learned that you could do 15 seconds of free music, you would not be no copyright claim upon them if they were in their library. So I said, I put my thinking cap on and I said, I know what I'll do is I'll buy a rotating display case. They use them for modeling. You know, like say I wanted to show my little Beatles cup here. So you put it on the little tray and it just rotates slowly. Look at that. Oh, yeah, Stars and Stripes, Old Glory. And then the Beatles, right? And so you could say, put that cup on there if you wanted to do a video describing the item you had bought, a rare item or something, a model or whatever, and you put it on there. And then what happened was I said, okay, I'll do that. I'll put my CDs on there. I'll get Sue come in to help me because she's very good graphically. You should see this beautiful. Did you put the picture on Instagram? All right. On Instagram, maybe I'll show you that a little later in the show. Anyway, it's just wonderful. And So I was doing that, and then I had a sound clip. So yesterday I put on Foreigner. I think it was Cold as Ice I put on. But YouTube then said, oh, we can't have that. And in those days, I wasn't saving my live streams. So long story longer, they demonetized me for that. Nothing really untoward occurring on my part. I'm all within the confines of legitimacy. But it wasn't good enough for them. They demonetized me. And they were looking to save money anyway. YouTube has its challenges. Rachel's liberal heroes. Yes, Joel, absolutely. Rachel would have a crowd of five. I'd be over on Rumble, one of the other platforms. I'd have to, you know, vacate liberal YouTube. And, you know, in fairness, because a lot of stuff, but in the old day, things are a lot different. Half the Trumpy bears, Rachel's already banned for being horrible people. Nobody's horrible. Like, even lovely Ruth Ann. I don't have anything against Ruth Ann. It's just that I was getting a little wearied out with all the thing on waxed all the time. And then she come in, and then the final straw And she goes, "You're a hypocrite for calling rice patties rice." I just, what the fuck? I just wasn't in the mood for it. I said, not going to happen. I'm tired. It means nothing. You know, she's not a record collector or anything. And she didn't contribute a whole lot, but she was a nice lady. Right. And now she's got a new place. She's out with Marius and having great adventures with the UKIP, the UK crowd. And so it's great. So she's found a good place and a home, and that's all anybody ever requires. Now, there was some bad news coming. I did understand something that happened. YouTube isn't liberal. Oh, John, it is. YouTube's hugely liberal. I can't talk about the thing that happened that made everybody sick. Remember that thing? You couldn't talk about that. You can't talk on YouTube about the a certain election that happened and some questions. You can't talk about that. That ain't us conservatives saying no to that. Who the fuck owns that? So what happened? We found also that the there's a whole thing, and this is why actually it's quite interesting. A lot of the mainstream media is kind of losing their audience in big time quickly. They're hemorrhaging. Fox News. Somebody put a meme out, you know, with all the percentages down, but they're all down. I like the pictures of Kitchen Reno on Instagram, says Eric. Well, that's goosey. Let's agree it's 50%. It's a bigger psyop from the other side. I'll tell you why. There, we had two impeachments. One of them was based in part on colluding. Let's call him Rump. Rump was colluding with the Ruskies, and that never happened. The PP dossier, the Steele dossier discredited. It's unbelievable. And then the latest thing is, you Democrats, heroes of free speech, etc. Good old Rump, exactly. You guys, and then they've arrested some reporter? Like, what the hell is going on? So, sounds like Trump will have no problem defending. So why, what's the delay? It's just financial. They're trying to cut him off at the knees. Exorbitant fines. For defamation, $83 million for defamation. I should sue you fuckers for defamation, $83 million off of each of you. But it's politically motivated. It's in New York where it's going to be like that. It's like if I put Trump on trial with you morons. What do you think would happen? They'd lock, where's the key? Oh, we threw that away. He's locked up. Lock him up. Costs more to delay. Everything will be going. He's got some good people there. It'll take time. He'll take care of it. It's all good. Your beloved Mark Dice has been taken down on YouTube previously. He's actually been taken down before. He's back up, but he's been taken down a number of times. Yeah. He's been demonetized. A lot of people. Jonathan Turley. Demonetized. JB, I'm praying for the day Trump is jailed. See, that's the problem, right? I don't pray for the day. I don't sit there, oh, Lord, can you please lock up Hillary Clinton? I mean, what the fuck's wrong with you? Think about that, JB. Give your head a fucking shake. Because he spews. And there's a whole thing. And then we had, what's his name? The big one was, what's Alex Jones is an idiot, by the way, with the rubber black gloves, the naked. That guy's a nut. But I'm telling you, he should still be allowed to talk about frogs and hormones or whatever the fuck he wants to talk about, whatever the hell he wants to say. You know, that's his business. That's free speech. Say it. Nobody has to watch you, your stupid opinion. Okay. Trump is being set up by pseudo liberals. Will light ever dawn on Rachel's marble head? I'm praying it will. Maybe. We have to see. I pray for the day I meet Rachel. Me too, Chauncey. I like you. Nobody was saying, yeah, you can say it, but nobody was doing it. No one was doing it. The Republican at the Capitol, like, they're useless, right? And there were a bunch of neocons. And they just talk a big game and nothing ever happens. You go, we're going to go do this. You go, oh, yeah, we'll see where that goes. And so it's the whole thing. The latest is FBI informant, which was good up until September of 2023. And it's being said he's like a Republican informant. He's not. He was an FBI informant. They used him, the FBI. He was good up until September 23. But then he said he had some info on Hunter. And suddenly that became, quote, an inconvenient truth. But corruption runs deep. We'll see where it all goes. We'll see in time where it all goes. But yeah, it's really interesting. And, you know, he had his thing. I think he was trying to reach out to these neocons and try and bridge some sort of detente, and it was never able to happen. He was on the revenue. He was on reply. But he wasn't their guy. He was the FBI guy. Okay? So talk to the FBI about it, because the FBI was using him. Does Trump have a good, no, he does not have a good relationship with Fox News. In fact, Biden just sent a memo was just published with the Biden administration saying, hey, can you knock off the impeachment talk about Biden, please? No more talking about it. And we don't like Brett Beyer. We don't like that guy. There's a bunch of guys over there, Lou Dobbs. We don't want him. We like Geraldo. And I was talking about Geraldo yesterday. Geraldo was skew. Okay. So. What now? What's going fake about it? He was good. He really likes me. Patty's Jr. I know what's going on. Surprised you and Waxed aren't offended. Guess he has to try harder. I don't know. I guess did you get an attack on you, Rice Patty's Jr.? I hope not. Great channel name. Yeah, and we got problems with the CBC. The government's just throwing money off to these things. So they work hand in hand with the government because they're paid by the government. They become basically propaganda arms up here. Very problematic. If the Dems think Trump's an existential threat to the solar system, why are they running a senile old man with a 39% approval rating? They will get him out. They are going to replace him. Dems are going to get rid of him. Rachel is picking out common suitor narratives, so much sense, but not the right things like fake account. I don't now stop it, Luki. You've settled down. I've spent so much time in Facebook jail that I own an orange suit. Holy smokes. RFK is the only candidate with no Secret Service protection. He must be a viable alternative to two geriatrics. I'll tell you one thing about him, John, is that's horrendous. A guy named Kennedy that's running for political office. You have problems with CBC, my initials? No, I have no problem with Stundy. I have problems with the CBC, Canadian Broadcasting Corporation. RFK, but here's the thing. He should have. He's running for office, and he's just kind of a spoiler. I think he'll draw a little from Trump. He'll draw a little from Biden. But at the end of the day, he's kind of a Ross Perot figure, right? I'm neither Democrat or Republican. Neither am I. I just want the right man in office, not old people. I'm not ageist. I don't mind. If you can be old, as long as you're functioning, as long as you're got your wherewithal about you, then I'm all good for it. But if you he, who, what, mommy, then there's problems. Which is the door? How do I get out? How did I get here? Once in a lifetime, water flowing underground. For the people who don't accept stuff that they don't like, there's no helping them. No point with most of the Trump supporters who are left, Herc. Don't worry about those. They're just too far gone. Well, I'm telling you one thing, Scheinman. There's so much information that still keeps coming out. Are you anybody else watching? Like they now at the myocarditis issue? Go look up myocarditis, myocarditis. Go check that out. Look at that. Also look at sudden deaths. Do you know that England had to redefine how they count deaths? Unexpected, an increase in unexplained deaths. There was too many of them. And so now they've calculated how they count that statistic. It looks better now. By basically brainwashed our Rachie, like Rush brainwashed my grandmother, Rush Limbaugh. I wouldn't want to change you, Rach. Thank you, Simon. Sudden death is the HK segment already. Holy smokes. Yeah, there is an increase. That's statistical. I watched Dr. Campbell. He's a good channel. He's on YouTube. He has to be very careful what he said. He's been taken off YouTube before too, but then they let him back on. And we've got right now a new bill in Canada. It's the anti-hate speech bill. They can throw you in life in prison. And also you can report on somebody. Remember during World War II, some place in Germany, you could report on people. Says not to offend to us. Oh, well, we'll go visit them. We'll see what they have to say. I tell you, one of the scariest things. Yeah, Campbell's he's incredible. He's very, very good. Very logical guy who came from one side of a position on an issue. He was a little soldier all in line. And they ended up on the other side. Very, very interesting. Rachel Campbell pandered. No, that's a disservice, Herc, to him. You're a smart man, Herc. Use that keen intellect. The guy came from an opposite side of an argument and moved. He evolved. Some guy put together a video showing the evolution of this guy, how his first videos were talking about it and everything. He actually was just as a kind of a medically trained individual, went in there and went, holy fuck, you know, and slowly kind of had an awakening about it all. It's very, very interesting. Dr. Rogan, holy smokes. Okay, I want leaders who will untether our fate from the grits of corporations, the industry of war. That'd be nice. Pat, you're so right about that. Here's the deal, right? You got this pyramid of powers, right? So you got the electorate, right, at the base of it all. And then on top of us, we have our elected officials to represent us, right? And then on top of them, you have like organization, like World Health Organization, World Economic Forum, and the military. And these guys start influencing them. Then on top of them, you got the banks. And then on top of the banks, you know, and it goes like, you know, it forms a pyramid structure. It's kind of interesting. Trust me, Richard, I've watched him skew data in real time over the years. He knows where his bread is buttered. I don't believe that at all. I have a totally different opinion. What does Jordan Peterson have to say about Renee's major character breakthrough once he has Beetle Babe on the screen? I think Renee did really good. He had some good questions he was throwing out. I think he'd do good with his own live stream, something he can maybe play with, toy with. Okay. I can't, you know, Joel, that's the thing. That kind of comment that you're reading, I cannot even, I won't put that up. But that's because I'm not too sure about what YouTube would say about that, you know. And there's a lot of things. And you could not talk about the election. That was verboten. And so in Canada, we have the same problem. A lot of censorship here in Canada. You know, they cut off people's, what did they say? Their payments, like their bank accounts were frozen, right? The Bible, because I'm a Christian, that's where a lot of my bias comes from. It's not Trump. It's ultimately at the Bible where it comes from me. It says that the Antichrist, little children, you shall hear that Antichrist will come, is already in the world, and that everyone will receive a mark, right? Either on their forehead or on their head, whether it's a literal mark or whether it means just your industry with the things that you do with your hands, your work, you know, idle hands, devil's workshop sort of idea. More symbolic, if you will. And then the forehead, our thinking, our ideas, right? But regardless of which, it's interesting that without that mark, you can neither buy nor sell. So it's an economic sanction. They hit you where you live. Just reported for jury duty. They told me they don't meet today. I'll be summoned back in September. Well, that's a thing. What the fuck? 106, 106, 106, 106. It's happening all over, Mike. Mike, I'm sure you are enjoying the benefits of your Rega P6, which you just got. They're best Josie. Oh my God, that's a bad title for a name. Trudeau is fed. I wouldn't know about that. You know, I know the rumors about it. He looks like the guy when they do the photo, but that's, you need just DNA will prove it. All you need to do is do a DNA test, right? And we'd know really quick, very quickly. When they didn't call me for jury duty, I got a 2-year reprieve in that. Rachel, now don't speak that into reality, though. Thoughts turn into things. I don't believe that. If I could do that, I said, please, I want Mjolnir, the very Thor of the hammer of Thor, to appear in my hand now. You cannot, you can, that's magic. Okay.
I've been wishing for that butcher cover for quite a while.
I want the, butcher cover, come to me now. Wow, that is incredible. Second state, first state, and third state, too, right? You can't. That's magic. I don't believe in magic. Do you believe in magic in a young girl's heart? Okay, I love this. I can't remember who else talked to Jen on yesterday's show, but Renee was by far the most natural. I thought it was beautiful. It's not instant, Rachel, obviously. It's not anything, Nick. It can't be true. This is not, there's no science to that. Rachel, you are unironically maybe, making fun of religion. Well, I'm not a religionist, right? Religion is magic, you know, ritual, right? Christ spoke to the Pharisees, you, through your traditions, have made null of the power of God. You deny, you actually make the power of God to none effect through your rituals and your religious practice. How about this? The Jews worship God, right? Jehovah, Adonai, Jehovah Jireh, the Lord provides. And they worship the great God, right? And then God, the Word, becomes flesh and dwelt amongst us. Beheld his glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And there it is, God manifested in flesh before him. The Jews don't even recognize their own God whom they worship. That's the nature of religion. It perverts perspective. It perverts perspective. Anyway, I've been watching a lot of Star Trek, as you know, so I'm incorporating Bill Shatner into my repertoire. I am going to be bust up when that guy goes. I love Bill Shatner. It's unironically stated that when I was in Hollywood, I went down looking for Rob there down at the boardwalk with the rollerblades and stuff in Muscle Beach. But I took a detour down Hollywood and Boulevard, and I'm walking along with all the stars, and there's Bill Shatner. I had to take a picture of it. I got one stars picture of all the stars, and it was William Shatner. What a thing. And the day I was there, Star Trek V, so it dates when I was down there, it was Star Trek V was in the theater right across from Groma's Chinese Theater. I hope to meet Shat at a convention in April. God bless you, Joe. I love that guy. And people have problems with him, big ego. But in those days, you got to understand that it was all about being the star of the show, right? Head billing, starring William Shatner. And when I go back and watch, yeah, they call him the Shat, is short, you know, diminutive of Shatner. And when you go back there and you watch the show, the first season of Star Trek, of course, in the third series, they changed the color from gold or yellow to the blue, which I thought was superior, but still nice to have both. And then what you got is, yeah, you got this great intro, and it got, you know, some woo-woo, Alexander Courage theme. And it says Star Trek, starring William Shatner. There goes the producer. Yeah, well, that, you can walk back and forth. Your show too. So William Shatner starring, and then also starring Leonard Nimoy. And that's it. But then the second season, they changed it. William Shatner, Leonard Nimoy, and DeForest Kelly, which I thought was fair. And then the third season, they changed the font from yellow to blue. So that was all there. I saw Shatner speak at the Rosemont Theater here at Rosemont, Illinois. He doesn't watch much of the old episodes. If I was him, I sure the hell would. Boy, was he good looking. Holy smokes. That guy was so handsome. Okay. I'm going to sense out how it goes with Shatner. Chachi. Oh, I found out about the reason why. Did you hear about this? That him and Nimoy became friends. Him, Nimoy, and DeForest Kelly really did become friends. You know, they were more working mates, but They were more than acquaintances. They knew each other well. They were co-workers, but they liked each other and they were friends. But then what happened at the end of the day, we had a situation where Trump was doing the documentary called The Captains. He approached Leonard, Mr. Nimoy. Leonard, could you do this for me? Be in the show. He goes, no, I'm not a captain. I don't want to be there. You don't need me. Do The Captains. This is a captain thing. Go away. If you want for first officer one, maybe I could do that. You know, him and, you know, Will, what was his name? The one that with the beard that was helping Picard out, that guy. Anyway, all the little helper assistants, best boys. And so you got this whole situation. He's a star. Those guys get along. But he wants Nimoy in. Nimoy doesn't want in. They are at a convention, and Bill, he took pictures, and he had some film footage of McCoy there, or Spock there, Leonard Nimoy. Nimoy didn't like it, and he said, screw this. I am pissed off. You're using footage of me without my permission, you bastard. And that's the end of it. Yeah, the transformative man, which is great. This is the Bill Shatner record. I need to get that. Rachel, what do you think? Hardly any Trumpy Bears come to your TV show? Probably because I'm too friendly and too sweet. But no, you know what? I think it is. I think more people in the music and the rock and roll thing lean more to the left than the right. And I think the right wing people aren't as interested in that. He was a trans man. Yeah. I like Dave Chappelle. Chappelle's hilarious. He got attacked, some guy tried to kill him. And he goes, it was a trans man. It's so funny. I mean, to have the wherewithal to crack a joke under that stress scene, crazy, crazy. How did Trump do in the Washington primary? He got clobbered. He got slaughtered. Haley Mill, this is her heart. I'm so excited. She has won that. So it's now 200 and some odd delegates for Trump against Haley, who's got 19 or so. So we'll see what happens. Today, North Dakota goes and a couple other states. And then tomorrow, what's going to happen is Super Tuesday. Trump should win every single state, both today and tomorrow. I believe that Haley Mills had one shot at winning one district, one group of electorates, and that was in D.C. Mission accomplished. And now she's about to get slaughtered and embarrassed. You know, she pulled zero delegates out of Idaho. See, what happens is that primaries, they allow Democrats to vote. So a lot of them are out and forced to kind of, and they've got people on say, who are you voting for? You know, I'm voting Haley Mills. And well, that's fantastic. They go, and who are you going to vote for in the general then? And the guy goes, oh, Biden, obviously. Like, so they're just running against Trump. That's all the deal, right? All right. I think there's more of us in the community that speak up, but we're scared to say anything since we get attacked the minute we do. You have to have I don't know, what do you call it? You know, you got to have a strong disposition, you know, in order to handle the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune. Yeah, see, I don't give a fuck about that. You, Simon, do you fucking care? Who do I care who anybody's fucking? That's their business in the privacy of your own bedroom. You're the kind of guy, Simon, that get mad at gay people because you don't like who they're sleeping with. Maybe you should keep your eyes out of their bedrooms. Okay? You should be tolerant, Simon, with people's sexual proclivities. Okay? Let's not be so holier than thou. You guys sound like a bunch of Southern Baptists, not to hurt your feelings, but this is where it's going. But yeah, Pie Face, come on, get out of the bedroom. Okay. Haley Mills was terrific in the Parent Trap, but she didn't do as well in Idaho. Okay. What do you think about that feeling? Everything about super interesting. Trump doesn't have racist rhetoric at all. Trump's got a lot. Have you seen the beautiful black people supporting Trump? I love them. They come out. It's just hilarious. One black guy comes out, goes, he's got a, I guess he's a big podcaster. He's got like a million subs or something. And the guy comes out, he's a black guy. And he's going, what the hell? Joe Biden comes in eating fried chicken with black people? Can you imagine if Trump did that? What the hell they'd do to Trump with that? And he's so right. Black people see it. You can't pander to them. I mean, you know, because they're honest and sincere. They say, yeah, that's kind of bullshit. You know, it's just unbelievable. Jimmy Barnes was dead. Jimmy. Oh, no. Jimmy again. What did he say this time? Jimmy Barnes seems unhinged. Well, okay. What did he say? Jimmy, if you're watching, I want to give you shit, you son of a bitch. If he's shitting on me, I'll just take care of that. Okay, Jimmy Barnes. Okay, let's go. First of all, I'll promote him. Jimmy Barnes. Okay, VC. Let's go vinyl. Well, this is unfortunate. Jimmy has become totally evil now. Jimmy Barnes. There he is. Jimmy Barnes Show. Okay. Home. Okay, now. Okay, this is why things are stupid. Share screen. Okay, here's Jimmy. Now we're going to give him a shout out and promote him. Here's Jimmy. Nice guy, right? He's got 2,380 plus subscribers. And you'll see I'm subscribed. Well, if he's talking shit about me, and then we just do this, right? Unsubscribe. See what's happening? There. It's as simple as that. Okay, Jimmy, you're done. And then the other thing I'm going to do, and I did this with William, is I'll just take his wrench away next time he shows up. So I'll just, you know, kill the wrench thing. And that'll be it. And then it'll be up to you. Rage in the politics zone. Go Israel. Absolutely. If you want to know who I cheer for in that conflict, I cheer for Israel. Sir William Honoré, a big shout out to Jimmy Barnes of UKVC. Well, that's fine. That's free speech. I assume you don't have a wrench, Sir William Honoré, UKVC. Good luck living here. I believe you've probably already been hit. Scoozy is attractive. I can't deny it. Don't rate her testing man much, but that's her business. Thank you, Rice Patties Jr. That was his quote. Oh, okay. Well, you know, there you go. That's okay. Anyway, I just unwrenched him and I unsubbed and then he can just go. A public derenching. You know, it's like that old show, the soldier show, Chuck Connors. And it was branded. He was branded a coward. And they took his epaulets off, you know, right? They busted him. They broke his sword, threw it in the dirt. That's it for you, cowpony. And that was the end of that day. That was just horrible. Anyway, so that's the deal. Yeah, probably I'd be more concerned. Career politicians are a problem. But anyway, we watch Super Tuesday tomorrow. That's happening later. Bill K. branded, Rachel. That's right. That's what it was. Okay, what am I going to do here now? I want to start the invitation. We'll start talking some music. That's fun. The Bee Gees are gold. There's an album, I believe, called Bee Gees Gold. Folks, in terms of record buying, I may get a record delivered today. It's snow everywhere. But the one I'm getting is a new John Squire, Liam Gallagher, late of Oasis. Those guys have put out an album. It's expensive, Sue. It cost us $60 for that thing. For the John Squire, Liam Gallagher album.
Oh, it's that's good. Okay, hon.
Yeah, it's orange. It's a special. I don't know if it's an Amazon special version of it.
You go buy that, hon. Or maybe you already did.
I already did, babe. And it's on its way. Rob, welcome to the show. Mm-hmm. I had a public derenching of Jimmy Barnes. Well, he hasn't been deranged publicly yet.
Well, was he here this morning?
Well, he's talking smack about me, and so I just said.
Yeah, but was he here commenting?
I guess he was commenting on one of those streams the kids told me about. A report has been brought.
I don't even know who he is.
He's an English guy.
What's his problem?
Me, apparently. So anyway, that's just the
Rachel, let me ask you a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
How many YouTube channels do you think there are? Not just everything. Hundreds of thousands. Maybe millions. Millions.
Yeah.
Do you know something? I don't go to most of YouTube channels. Yeah. I don't go there. I don't go watch them. I don't participate in any of them. That's amazing how someone can do that. I'm being ignored.
Hi, Eric. You're doing good. I'm listening to you. I let you talk to the people out there, Rob. You're very my mi casa tu casa. These are your people. Okay? Speak to your people for the love of God, man.
Who's Jimmy Barnes' people? I don't know who he is.
Okay. He's a nice boy. It's just he talks smack, apparently. And what's apparently PB Thales brought a report. Now we've got another report coming in. So it's not just one person saying.
Yeah, but I mean, again, who is Jimmy Barnes? Does he matter?
He's just one of our people in the vinyl community, Rob. He's in the United Kingdom.
But does he matter? Does he do anything? Do people go, hey, did you hear what Jimmy Barnes said the other night?
It's not like that. But he's been a member in good standing here, embraced, encouraged, promoted. You know, I've done a lot of good for him, you know?
Hey, Rachel.
Now, you know what happened? Okay, what do we got here? Copy link.
I want to show you a new watch.
Oh, okay. Hold on. I got to go in the
Did you get it from Jimmy Barnes?
No, it's not mine. It's going to release this year.
Okay.
And I want you to see how you react to it. And
okay. All right. Hang on. I got to go to link. Open link a new thing. All right. Hang on. Oh. When is this coming out? When is this arriving to me?
I'll have to check. It's in Italian, I think.
Okay, hang on. Okay, so we got something very special lined up. And Beetle Babe, you're welcome to join us if you feel like it. Up to you entirely. Got it. Here it is. Wow, look at that, everybody. That is pretty, pretty, pretty. What do you think about this, Wild Community? Hard Day's Night. So does it come complete with a little graphic image of the record like that, a Hard Day's Night like that?
No, if you scroll down, you can see that the dial has the names of the tracks. Are you getting it, all of it? Just scroll down a little.
Okay. Oh, okay. Can you guys see this? Are you seeing the scroll down?
It's not moving.
Oh, hang on. I got to go down here. I opened it up in two spots. There's the one I want. Okay, look at this. Anytime at all, I'll cry instead. Things we said today. When I get home, you can't do that. I told you before. Oh, you can't do that. If I fell in love with you, I should have known better. And I'm happy just to dance with you. And I love her. Tell me why you cried. Can't buy me love, you know, anytime at all. Da-da-da. Beautiful. And it comes either with a kind of the metal bracelet or the leather, right?
Yeah.
That is fantastic, these.
Scroll it down a little. There's more.
There's more. Okay. Look at the box. 60th anniversary, Hard Day's Night, right? 1964. Yeah. At 2024, 60 years ago, by God, the Beatles available Apple Corps Limited, a Beatles product, trademark, Paul McCartney, John Lennon, Ringo and George, all autographed.
And go down further.
It's so weird with the autographs, though, because I would put Ringo over Ringo, George over George, and Paul over Paul, and John over John, but that's just me. Okay. Oh, I see. Yeah. And there it is. Signature edition. Very nice.
And then you have look at the case back. You see,
okay, there's only the back of it.
There's only 1964 watches being made. It's a limited edition.
So one of 1,964 of these are going to be available in the world.
Oh, they're going to be. Yeah. Oh, so you got to get one now. You got to start.
Yeah, because people get it. Let's do a GoFundMe for me. I know everyone will want to buy this for me.
Yeah.
Rob, thank you so much, Deese. That's incredible. Sure. Now, so Rob, is this something you'd like to help me out get with your money to buy me, to help as a GoFundMe for Rachel Beetle Watch official project?
What?
Well, like I'm saying that you could know the thing. It's a Beatles project. Product.
Right.
Leather is the preference.
Can you change the name of the stream to Give Me, Get Me, I Want?
Give Me, Get Me. Give Me, Get Me anytime you fret me. Dana Kimowitz, wasn't me. My stepdad was there falling asleep. His energies were spent trolling and coalition buildings for other wayward periods since. It is just crazy what goes on in this final community. Henry Lemoine, I'm looking forward to the four Beatle biopics. Great news for Beatle fans. He doesn't have a room. I know Henry doesn't, but he's been around somebody. He's like, it's a stunty. Is who Henry? Who the hell are you? Who are you, mysterious visitor from another planet? Rob, are you into the whole UFO phenomena? Are you a believer in the aliens?
No, but
great question on my
part. No, but the stream has to be popular on Pluto or something.
I think it might be. Yeah, Rachel, that sounded like Ben Me Shapey you were singing. It did too. I'm a fan of Joe and Doc Docus's channel. Mm. Are you Invisible Ray, Henry Lemoine? Question. Yeah. Are you based in England?
Do you have fire damage to your face?
Yes. Were you involved in some sort of inflammatory conflagration?
Right.
Okay. Don't time out Henry yet. Sue is working on the case. We're going to get to the bottom of this man's identity. Okay, he's been around for a year now. He's a year old. No, I'm not LOL, not Ray. All right, Rob, what is your discernment telling you about this guy, Henry Lemoine?
It's always good to ask how you found this place.
Okay. How did you find the place, Henry Lemoine? Great question. Great. Rob's good at this.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll take a preemptive pose. I'm going to wrench him preemptively as an
You might regret it.
Well, we're just got to see. What is your opinion of Rob the Wax? That's usually a telltale question.
Yeah, well, you'll wrench him because he'll say, I find him unappealing.
What the hell's gone on with Deese? Look what's happened to Deese. He's become a gun guy.
Henri Lamont.
That looks like a second rate.
Okay, Joe can vouch for me. I found the place because I know Joe comes here. Well, Joe does. We love Joe. Joe's my favorite Beatle channel. Joe himself says he's not the best place. My favorite.
Hold on, Rachel.
Yeah.
Beatle Babe has a suggestion.
Okay, hold on. I'm going up to you.
You might very well regret wrenching him.
Beatle Babe, Jen, how come you weren't up here helping guiding? Right. I have to rely on Rob.
Henry, what place on this planet are you from?
Okay, good question. Joe has known me for three years, but he had a different name then. Joe likes to block him from his channel, though.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, what's going on?
Googly Moogly.
Uh-oh. Henry Lemoine said Beetle Babe inappropriate pictures. Block him. This is from longtime viewer, first-time commenter. Googly Moogly. Holy smoke. Googly Moogly. Yep. What? Beetle Babe, get up here. This is it. I can't believe it. Get up here. You know more about all this than I do. We got to get to the bottom of this YouTube drama. Rob, are you frightened? Has anybody tried to send you sexy pictures of themselves? Other than me.
Rachel, endlessly send me pictures of your pinkies thinking that does something for me.
I do the one where I bite my nail furtively.
Okay, she's coming up shortly.
I will be there. Okay, thank you, because we need your help on this case.
Rachel, this practice of just willy-nilly wrenching
people. What's he doing now? I love wrenches.
Brad is hoping that her back.
Hey, Rachel. Rachel.
Yes.
Yesterday, guess who I talked to in person?
Oh, okay. Hold on. Let me think. Jazz Mom's Chris.
He doesn't live in the same
place. Yeah, but he made a trip and he came out just to see you, and you met him and you talked to him.
Yeah, he strapped on a diaper and drove straight here, right? No.
That would have been Andy Star Trek. He
showed the person's comet.
Okay, look at this. I'm just a chill guy. I'm not causing any trouble anytime.
Okay, where are you? I'm from that area. So where in Virginia are you from?
Okay, Henry, we're getting to the bottom of your Virginia roots. I'm sorry, Deese, we have to do this. This is intense. This could be on all of us.
I don't have Stay Puft anymore, you know?
Okay, he's from Roanoke.
Okay, you always have to suspect someone from Roanoke has a few sandwiches short of a picnic, Rachel.
Leave Jen alone with her beautiful curtain decor.
Hey, Rachel, ask Henry if he likes peanut soup.
Okay, Googly Moogie says, chill guy, don't send new pictures. You had no clothes on. You sent those to a girl? What the hell? Give your head a shake there. Googly Moogly, you're so right. Has Googly got a wrench? No. Googly, hang on. Googly's a friend.
Stop right there, Rachel. Don't wrench Googly.
Don't time out. Bill K, you timed out Googly.
Yes. Thank you, Bill K.
Okay, hold on. Okay, Googly, you're back in as friends. Googly is rich. Googly is doing the Lord's work here, it seems. Deese, what are you doing, buddy?
I'm here.
Okay, well, I'm just concerned that you're getting lost.
I'm being abducted by Grace.
Thank God Vinyl Dan's here.
Okay, Vinyl Dan says so many of us said, look at this.
Alexandria was where my grandparents-in-law lived.
Yes. I got, the strangest comment from, let me go look on my show. It was just crazy what happened to your channel. Go here. And I got to look up. This is one of my biggest videos ever. Journey, Don't Stop Believing. It scored 17,000 plus views. And, okay. And it I got to go all the way to the bottom of probably the latest comment. It was just a crazy one. It's from poopy.butthole. Anybody subscribe to Poopy Butthole? But Poopy Butthole just kind of went meh on it. And then I go, not a fan, Poopy.
Well, Rachel.
Yeah.
I know several Poopy Buttholes. What middle name does this one have?
It's just Poopy Dot. There's a dot there.
Oh, Poopy, I don't know Poopy Dot.
It's Poopy Dot Butthole. I don't know what to do with it.
Rachel, it's an Eastern European name.
Is it?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Okay, so then comments. Okay, let's see what else we got. Oh, wow, look at this. Chuck was... Okay, no, okay, I got to okay this. I got to okay
Did
this.
Googly a wrench?
Yeah, Googly's wrench. Okay, Googly's our friend. Googly friend.
Rachel, I do know a hairy poopy butthole, but I don't know a poopy butthole.
Okay. Okay, yeah, this is, Seb is right about this. Stinky Whistle Teeth brought a very positive message. Loki and Bill timed him out. Please don't time out Stinky Whistle Teeth. Rachel, remember, that's because you're acting like a nizzle tweed. Okay. Now, hopefully, Beetle Babe will tell the truth now that she's here. She's a lovely woman and a great new guest. What do you think about that, Rob? That's an encouraging comment from Google.
Hold on. At least...
I love Googly.
Hold on, Rachel. At least Henry said who he is and where he's from. Who are you, Googly Boogly?
Dana seems to be sticking up for...
okay, Dana is in... Okay, Dana, I trust.
I can vouch for Googly Moogly.
I can vouch for Googly Moogly. He likes an avant-garde music and long watches on the beach at sunset. He's a romantic.
Well, what's a long watch?
Oh, okay. Stinky Whistle Teeth is here. No hard visit. Time out. I am here to spread joy. Stinky, I'm giving you a wrench. Gosh, there's so many wrenchings occurring. This is a red letter day final candidate.
Yeah, Rachel's blindly giving people wrenches. Okay, all the haters, come on.
Okay, hello. Okay.
Now we're going.
So to what they brought up actually was not why I was going to say you might regret wrenching him.
Okay,
that had nothing to do with it, but that did happen, and yeah, a lot of the VP knew about it when it happened.
Okay,
but
don't send pictures naked to me, okay, girls. We don't. It's not what we're into most of.
Rachel.
Yeah. Son. Oh, Rob. Now,
oh, no.
Okay, that's horrible.
No.
Okay, Stinko,
no.
We're getting. Okay.
Stinky reference. I love the Ren and Stimpy reference.
Okay, who are the people you love and know? Like, who are these people? You seem to know them all. Googly and all the.
Don't know Googly. I'm just responding to them, but it does make me wonder who they are, really, given that they knew about that. I'm like, I'm not sure who you actually are. But.
Yeah. Now, have you ever had trouble with any other male individuals?
No, Henry was the only one in my 39 years on this planet, only one who has ever done that. That's like, what? But no, only reason I was going to say you might regret wrenching him is because he has a tendency on other streams to get very repetitive and kind of annoying. That was all I was going to say. That was literally all I was going to say.
Well, that's the MO of our beloved, what's his name, Rob, the pickup artist guy.
Mm. Hey, Rachel, the good old trustworthy Vinyl Dan has a good comment.
Okay. Beetle Babe. Oh, well, Jen, you can read this. There you go. Read it out loud for the children.
Beetle Babe seems to have brought a posse.
Okay. Is there any truth to that?
I don't know. I didn't intend on having them follow, but I guess it happened. I think he came over here because he saw Joe commenting, more likely, but...
Moogly's from New York, folks.
Okay, then. That doesn't really narrow it down much.
Well, I mean, he could be one of Joe's people in New York that knows Joe.
Could be. I mean, there's a lot of people that live in New York in general.
Hold on. Googly, do you like doing mall walks in the morning?
Rachel, maybe we should. No, we are not restricting Jen. Jen's too powerful. She's a real girl. Men demand that Jen be here each and every day if we can get her. Okay? She's a regular. I'm adopting this young lady. I always wanted a daughter of my own. Now I got one. Okay, here's the deal, Vinyl Community. We got 175 watching. We need to get the thumbs up. Okay, can we try put a little effort into the TV show, you little bastards? And at least, no, that's good that you did that. But what I mean is, like, there's a button on the thing and you can do it at the bottom.
Yeah. I already did that.
Okay, let's do it. Let's see what's doing. I'll do a refresh, see how many thumbs have we got. Okay, I'm kind of excited. Expect over 38? Rob, can you speak to that? How come there's only 38 up on what I
think? Last time I thought it was 16, so it's already gone up.
I know the reason.
Okay, go.
Your willy-nilliest of giving out wrenches to people has really turned people off.
Well, I don't know. Isn't it?
I think they demand more stern.
Now, Rob, I took a bad guess earlier in the show. I said it might be Chris that you met live. Was it Michael Fremmer that you met?
Rachel, it was Chauncey. I see him every time I go to the flea market.
Did I even mention that? He's one of ours. Okay, look at this. This is Astro Zombie.
I know him.
Okay, friend?
Yeah. Yep, he's cool.
Hang on, Astro Zombie. You're getting a wrench on the Rachel's Coast TV show. Congratulations, woo! Young man or girl. I'm not sure. Okay, it's a guy. Okay, Beetle Babe, for you, werewolves or vampires? We're going to go around the panel. Werewolves. You're going with the werewolves. Deez, werewolf, vampire. Take your pick. Which clan?
Vampires, yeah.
Vampire? Cooler. Okay. Yeah. Even though you've got a very nice beard that would come in handy for werewolfing.
Yeah, but vampires are the whole Romania, Transylvania stuff. You know?
Yes, they are. Rob, yourself, being
well, Rachel, I'm throwing you a curveball because
These
are the type of horrific characters we deal with daily, and this is zombies. Okay. We have too many zombies around
here. Okay, so all you zombies in high places. Isn't that great? That's the Hooters. Okay, and me, I'm going to be team vampire, and I want to be in the ones that are sparkly.
Rachel,
the Twilight ones.
Yeah, what spurred this? What spurred the question?
Because I'm all into Team Edward. Oh, if you were were you Team Edward, I hope you would.
Rachel,
I've actually never seen it.
Hold on, Rachel. And I don't know if you know this. That whole Twilight series is a way to indoctrinate people into Mormonism. Did you know
that? It's not a tower curtain.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Are you telling me that this is all about that?
Yes.
Mormonism?
Yes.
What? No, I knew she was a Mormon, but I didn't know the connection for
her. How come you're only conveniently have conspiracy theories and it can't apply to almost everything?
Okay, now listen. Jen, I've got a suggestion for your set. Okay. Here we go. Rob, what do you think about this for Jen? We get her the Rachel's Ghost shower curtain. We got a few, and they come in a variety of great colors. Cheerful. Look at this little spring light. Okay, and in the fall, it's perfect for Halloween. Rachel,
I can commend you for stumbling your way into a product placement.
I love this. Thank you, Rob. Anyway, it's incredible. And look at the beautiful, I love the seafoam green. Don't you?
See the pink option.
Yeah. Anyway, Jen, I highly recommend get a string a few of those together. You got it yourself a backdrop. Are they mold and mildew free? Yes, Peter, they are.
No, anyway, they're not.
That's incredible.
You asked that question as the color of mold is that shower curtain.
Hey, this is a weird one. Rob, can you read this? I had no idea about this.
Did you know Rob's live streams are actually made to turn people off of jazz?
Oh, my God.
Mean.
No, here's where you're wrong, Glassman.
Look out,
they're made to turn people off just in general.
Oh, no, I don't see you that way. Okay, Gus is here. Too many ghosts for a single bath. This is Gus' criticism. What would you prefer, like one big logo, super gigantic ghost logo, because I'll design it. If you have the need, I will meet it.
Rachel, how much is that money grab shower curtain?
The money grab shower curtain is 72 Canadian. So it's about $60.
How much is a shower curtain? It can't be like 50 bucks. Much.
Can you have my branding on it, you son of a bitch? Don't you even know math? Are you bad at your math?
And that's spring's price. We can't.
And yes, the spring's price. If we lower it, I don't make anything, Rob.
No, we'd have to pay you.
We'd have to pay you, Rob, to take it off our hands.
Well, don't you think that's the way it should be?
75 Canadian pays a good gravy, yes. Okay, I love this comment.
My sparkly mesh was $18, so sorry, I win.
Well, no, yeah, but it's not branded, darling. Like, you don't have the logo. You need a logo. By the way, I want to thank Music Talk with John, Clearwater, Florida. We're being brought to you by Kingfish Records out of Clearwater, Florida. Fantastic for all your record needs. Also, tomorrow we're probably going to be brought to you by InGroove. I hate even advertising another store if Mike's anywhere around. I just the humiliation, the hurt. I wouldn't want to do that to him. I love him. David Donnelly says, Patrick, thank you. Yeah, David's with us. David was in the hospital. We hope you're feeling better.
Henry LaPointe, the people that was commenting yesterday?
David was, he's a musician with David Bowie's friends.
Yeah, that was him.
That's him. And he's a recording artist. He's done a lot of stuff. Rachel, I'm surprised you're not selling the wrenches. You'd make a fortune. It's a good idea. It's possible. Anyway, we got that now. Okay, I love this comment. This is for you, Jen.
Beetle Babe has the gold lame Elvis suit as her background, and nothing is cooler than that. Actually, it's rose gold, but still.
Well, okay, now let's round the panel very quickly. Jen, Elvis fan.
I mean, I, for the longest time, did not appreciate him at all, but in the past year or two, I'm starting to warm up to him a little.
Okay, let's.
I mean, my birthday's the day before his, so I feel like obligated to at least like him a little. So.
Holy smokes, so you just had January, would have had your birthday.
Yeah.
Holy smokes.
January 7th.
Happy belated birthday.
Thank you.
Deese, okay, Elvis, do you like Elvis, Deese?
Yeah, baby.
Okay, well, you did kind of an Elvis, you did an Israeli.
I can, but of course.
I still detected it, Deese. It was still Elvis. Rob, what about you?
Fat Elvis, skinny Elvis, not so much.
Really? You went towards the end of the career.
I'm all about the tragedy of dying on the toilet, Rachel.
Okay, Rob, how do you handle these questions? They have been headhunting you for a long time. Deese, I'll let Deese read this because I don't want the two particulars get involved. I don't want to fight between Chad and Rob.
Hold on, Ray. So hold on, fake Pumpy Vinyl.
Okay, fake Pumpy Vinyl, be careful.
Your dislike of the regular Pumpy Vinyl greater or less than your dislike for me?
Okay, greater or less? Elvis is good, but kind of dated. The Beatles are 100% timeless. Henry Lemoine. I love Elvis. Elvis is incredible. I got the box set there. 60 albums are right in that thing of Elvis. And then this case here is just loaded chock full of Elvis Presley records. So I love Elvis, but everywhere else is Beatles. I tell you, a lot of Beatles. This is all Beatles. And then that all there is up to there is Beatles. And that's John Paul, George, and Ringo after there. And then there's box sets floating around all over the place with more Beatles and solo Beatles, et cetera, et cetera.
Rachel, there can only be one king. I mean, there's the king of pop, but there's only one king, a king. So,
yes.
You know, that's...
Well, that's a beautifully stated comment. Elvis is the king of rock and roll.
King, for all our UK friends, King Charles.
Rachel, are you a Queen fan? Henry!
Here we go.
Henry.
This is what he goes into every time. Fair warning.
Look at that. What's that? Holy smokes. I hope PB Thal's watching. This is the incredible Queen box set.
Hold on. Rachel, did you give Henry a wrench?
Yes, I love him.
Okay, now let me make a concocted conspiracy theory thing that you can align yourself with.
All right, go ahead.
What avatar picture does Henry have?
Okay, let's take it. He's got himself a De Niro, didn't he? Yeah, he's got
De Niro. What is De Niro famous for in your circles?
He's famous for Goodfellas.
No, he's one of the biggest harsh critics of your king.
Of my king?
Yes.
My Trumpy bear? Yeah, I know. Yeah.
That is a conspiracy theory, though.
Yeah, I just don't even care about that.
All about conspiracy theories.
Yeah, well, we got a cup in the merch store about that. If you want to buy merch, it's over there.
Can you? That's the only good thing you have in the merch store.
Rachel's Ghost, would you consider pursuing the Queen original UK? No, Peter, I'm not going to do it. I'm really happy. I'm very content with this. I've got a UK first press of Queen, A Night at the Opera.
Rachel. Jim gave me a UK first press.
All right, here we go. Beggar's Banquet.
Yeah, give me a nice UK first press. And it actually, my big complaint, their albums don't sound good. This actually sounds good.
Here's the thing with the Stones, okay? Now, what the Beatles had the great luxury of being at Abbey Road with their regular tech of engineers and teams everybody knew, like Norman Hurricane Smith, engineering everything from...
Oh, babe.
Yeah, that guy. From a Please Please Me all the way to Rubber Soul. That's quite the inventory for this guy, quite the resume. The Stones, on the other hand, would travel from studio to studio to studio. They never really had a single home base. And as a result, the records vary widely, even from tune to tune on a record. You'll be listening, you go, that sounds good, that sounds good, that sounds good. Whoa, what happened there? And so it's a more uneven affair you get with Rolling Stones pressings. Some great stuff in the Rolling Stones in mono box set, which is just there. The album there to get is Let It Bleed. Let It Bleed is the best sounding out of all those records. It's absolutely beautiful sounding album. And so if you're looking for kind of one of the best sounding Rolling Stone records of all time, Tattoo You did very well. I think that's a great sounding record.
Really good.
Yeah, I think it's a good sounding record. And the other one that I would cite would be Let It Bleed. Those two are kind of, they really stand apart as having great mixes, great mastering. Okay. I can't think why Sue, I only pointed out the inherent flaws in Sue's political belief. Oh, me, I guess. Musette and Love. Oh, yeah, there's romance going on there. We got a love triangle.
You don't worry about
that. Okay, I'll just let that go. Okay, we got it fine. All right, now, because you see, Rob and I are the hardcore record collectors here. Jen, now, in terms of your collection on CD, have you got all the Beatle albums on CD? Yeah. Okay, yeah. You got the catalog, you got anthology?
Of course, that was one of my starting places.
All right, so this is really good. So really, other than a Butcher album, there's not much you're needing or wanting or really...
I'm in U.S. albums I'm still trying to get.
Oh, okay.
And I'm always in the market for bootlegs and things, so...
Oh, okay.
Actually, well, I guess there technically is one mainline gap in my Beatle collection, and it's the Live at the BBC albums. I've never owned those.
Okay. So, yeah, and you don't have...
I always forget about them until I say that, and I'm like, actually, wait.
And do you have them on... are you wanting them on CD or on vinyl?
For me, preferably CD, just because it's more practical for me. Yeah. But I mean, either or, but...
Yeah. Now, are you an apartment dweller or a house dweller?
In a house.
Okay, so that usually gives you a little more optioning, because houses generally provide more room, right? So you can do more with it. Tattoo You is Outtakes Culled by Steve Lillywhite. It's still great. Well, Mitch, it sure sounds great, right?
It's one of their biggest albums, right?
Okay, so what? Okay, here's the thing, Jen. So what Loki wants... The camera's down low, which
is... Because there's nowhere for me to move this board on my desk. There's no more room. I have as far as I can bring it.
I think he's wanting full gold drapes. So a rotate, like a swiveling.
Swivel it, it goes off the other end.
If she doesn't have enough curtain, can we get a go?
I'd rather have the side with the wall than the one just going back into the room, because it's going to be off one side or the other.
You know, Jen, there's no two ways about it. First of all, we got to get you a new desk. We're going to go fund you a desk. The other thing we're GoFunding is Rachel's Go shower curtains, but with the logo show. Rob, go ahead.
You know, her background reminds me of that episode of Seinfeld, Rachel. You know that one?
Yeah, keep going, Rob.
The one where George's mom's in the hospital and he's...
Oh, yeah. I'm here for your sponge bath, Scott.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, what's behind it looks more like one of those, because it actually just is one of those canvas ones.
Well, it's just lovely. Now, we got a controversial comment here. None more controversial than this gentleman, Renee Kerman. I'm going to Dees. Can you read this for the kids? This is controversial.
Oh, boy.
I trust only you to go here with this.
Well, I have to.
I wouldn't touch this with a 100-foot ball. Yeah, that was an incredible Michael Jackson yell you did.
Shimon!
I was about to do it.
Okay, keep going.
If you're talking about King of Pop Michael Jackson, it's fact that he's a child molester. He got away with it because he has lots of money and he paid off the families with money.
Oh, my God. Okay, what do you think about that?
I know he paid one family like $22 million, so it's kind of sus. I don't know. But the FBI didn't find anything, so...
It seems like they would have found something if there was something actually to it. So I don't know. I personally give him benefit of the doubt. I know that's not a popular take, but that's just me.
I know this is sort of similar to what we're talking about. Rachel tried to force feed me Jesus shoes.
What?
I wanted to get him Jesus boots, the shoes, the sandals. I love this
Jesus color. Juice.
Okay, well, look at this, Rob. Read this comment. That is from your counterpart in the United Kingdom.
The stream used to be fun and groundbreaking. I guess every stream hits a brick wall. Are you talking about us or the VCUK?
They're talking about me.
What? He's not. That's Rob Walker. He loves you.
Rob Walker,
can you say nice things to Jen, please? You son of a bitch. I can't believe. Rob, I ordered up Liam Gallagher and John Squire's new album. It's coming maybe today. Okay. So think about that, Rob. Now, say nice things to Jen. I can't believe it. Clem Burke is the best-dressed guys I've ever met, including the jacket.
You know who he is.
Little babe zoom in or bring the camera. She's just...
I literally said it's as close as I can pull it on the desk.
You're going to drive. Are you nuts? Are you going to drive this young YouTuber crazy? Okay, let's see how the thumbs up we're doing a TV show. Because I think it's not good today. Okay, let's see. What do we got here? Okay. I don't want that open. I want this open. And I want to do a refresh. Hopefully, fingers crossed. Okay, we're just over the line. Just over. Just by one. Holy smokes, you people. Okay. Okay. Sava Dimitrov, critical of my album purchase. Was Beetle Babe not a regular on the Invisible Ray show back in the day, Jen? Full
back disclosure. In the day, I was, and then there was the falling out with Ray.
Okay, now what happened with
that? I don't want to go into that. It's still recent.
Recent one. Did he, what's the word for it? Did he?
That I made up with Joe Mayo.
Okay. So you made up with Joe, and that alienated Ray?
Yep. Yeah, and initially he claimed he was going to be fine. He was going to behave. I made one rule on my channel. One. Just don't talk shit about Joe. That shouldn't have made the sky fall, but he and one other guy did not hang with it, started crap, so I blocked him off my channel. So now, ever since, they decided to fabricate an entire story about me, about Joe, that is completely not at all based in fact. And it's just they're running with it for shits and giggles, and I don't care. I really don't. But at the same time, just like, that's why I don't go there anymore.
Mayo. Yeah, I mean, Invisible Ray's.
We call him fire victim Ray around here.
He's got his issue.
I mean, this isn't the first time that he's had goes at me. He's been doing this for close to 10 years. But this time I'm like, I'm just done with him now, though. Like 100%. This was his last shot. He went to rehab. I gave him the benefit of the doubt, thinking maybe he'd reformed. He showed his true colors. I'm like, if you're still doing this sober, I tap out. I'm done. That's it.
Okay, this is really interesting. I've sent out a shot of flare-up, and we're trying to get PB Thal on. PB Thal, you know what happened, PB Thal? I just got word that Jamie Barnes was shitting on me again, and so I've had to unsubscribe. Go ahead, Steph.
Brad came in and said something like he was posting comments the other day, but that's, I think, on this
stream. On this stream, he was doing stuff, too,
Literally yesterday, he tried to come up at the same time. I was like, he comes up, I'm gone. So.
Yeah, no, he's not coming up here. He never will. But he always tries to come up. So and he comes under different names. I check the account.
I think there's a way of like blocking an individual from being able to come up even in the green room. So
yeah, it's just in terms of IPs or whatever you do. I don't have anything against the guy, but he's just, it's too much. Like, we had him up here and he was very rude to some of our female guests, overtly sexual. In the crudest of terms, it was like Jose Marino Rancun, crude, if that helps you. Mean Mayo hates Invisible Races, Patrick. And Bill goes, Jaime was a prick or something, a jerk yesterday. Oh, well, that's the way it goes. But anyway, PB, if you can get up here, I don't know what you're doing, what your scheduling is with your morning meetings, but I'm curious. Let me know. Yeah, you get crude with your things. It's all sexual. It's too much. You know, we have a strict no sex policy. And see, the thing is, there's so much history, Henry, with me and Ray. Ray would go after me. I'm part Native American, so he would hit me on that. I'm transgender, so he'd hit me on that. And it's just like, I get it, but why bother, right?
Don't see the rules.
Well, it's all like it's like, don't be cruel to a heart. That's true. Anyway, so that's the thing. But I don't know, I don't hate Ray or anything like that. But, I think he's got substance abuse or a problem.
Yes, and that was why I kind of put up with it for a long time, because I saw it for what it was for a really long time. That's why I gave him a lot of rope, but this time he went way too far and I'm just done.
Well, I have a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
I've only seen like a couple of Ray's videos because he doesn't like me.
Yeah. Right.
How do you understand what he says? Because he has such a thick, clogged up way of talking that I can barely understand the words he says.
I don't know. His accent sounds very much like Peter Cook. So to me, I can understand him perfectly when he talks, but
Kingfish Records, Clearwater, Florida, is today's sponsor. That's fantastic. Holy smokes. Toe mail has arrived. Toe mail. Holy smokes. Joe, if you're if you're slumming here watching this thing, let me know. What do you want? How do you want? Do you want me to kill that thing? Let me know, Joe. Ray sounds like a Guy Ritchie movie. Yeah, he's
he sounds like and looks like a guy who was already done in a Guy Ritchie movie.
Oh my God, he's a Cockney and he's within the five miles of Mary LeBeau. He's a true Cockney. All right, Joe. Okay. I love everybody today. There may be pink colors to wear, but you're all awesome. I love that comment. Rachel, maybe the stream needs a bit of ranking of obscure bands. I don't think so. Don't think that's what's needed. What happened with Joe Mayo? He blocked me randomly. Has he been crabby pants lately or what? I don't know, Mikkel. Normally, Joe just calls it the way he sees it. He's a New Yorker. You know, New Yorkers can... If they wake up on the wrong side of the bed, you could be in trouble. Rachel, have you seen Killers of the Flower Moon yet? I have not seen it, Tom. I know it deals with Native American issues, big oil, good cast, Scorsese film. So it looks like it might be a good one. Have you seen the Flowers of the Killers of Flower Moon?
I've watched it. Yeah.
Please review, quick review.
Well, it was too long.
I haven't watched it yet because it's like 4 hours
long. Oppenheimer. Like, they could cut 30 minutes.
That's a big ask for me, 4 hours.
Yeah.
Well, my attention span starts to top out around 2 hours, so even three is pushing it. Four? I'm like, I don't know, maybe one day, but not yet.
Okay. Now, what do you think about it? Tom, what do you think my review would be? What do your instincts tell you? I'd be curious about that even before I see it. De Niro was fantastic. Obviously, Henry's a De Niro fan. De Niro's incredible. Taxi Driver, my God, Goodfellas, so many great films. De Niro's fantastic. Killers of Flower Moon played a great psychopath. Oh, boy, can he ever do that.
I liked him in Cape Fear as a psychopath. He was really good in that one.
Yeah.
Wow, I wish we could.
And My War with Grandpa, that was a good one, too. Do you know it?
Oh, geez. I've given up trying to figure you out, Rachel. Thanks. Yeah, I know. Many have tried. It can be a complex question. Me, Mr. Mayo, and Danny Daily live streams getting more popular each day. Yep. And so they should. I'm a big fan of Joe. I like the guy. He tells it the way it is, you know, or the way he sees it. He's a sincere guy. That's what I like about him. And I always respect that about Joe. Plus, nobody can do a rant video on something better than Joe Mayo. So
that's a fact.
You know, and Danny's a super nice guy. I love Danny. Well, he lurks here from time to time. From what I understand, he watches some of this stuff on his way to
work. We're Facebook friends, so.
Yeah. But Mayo should get a backdrop like Beetle Babe. That could be a thing.
No, his backdrop is fine. He's got like his whole collection behind him. His is great.
He doesn't need a backdrop. And that's what's great. And my friend AGK comes in here. He's got one of the best backgrounds going. Now, Joey Callio, who's in the band Seven Horse and Data from California, holy smokes, has this guy got some talent. Anyway, Flowers of the Killer Moon, Joey said. Joey, I think we're trying to get him back on the show in March. Hopefully get him. And I'm actually headed stateside in, I think, June in order to see Joey perform live with his band Data. And it's happening, and I'm looking for that. Rich, Danny watches stream every day. Well, he's a very nice man, and he's pretty damn good. I get so lost in who's mad at who. We need a previously. Previously on Rachel's Ghost. Absolutely. Oppenheimer was a great film, too. It's going to sweep the Oscars. I don't know about that. It is up against the Barbie girl. But
Barbie pretty much has been swept under the rug every single damn award it's been up for. Oppenheimer has kicked its ass, which hurts. But, I mean, it is what it is. But at least I get the satisfaction of Ryan Gosling is going to perform I'm Just Ken at the Oscars. So I'm still happy. I still win. I will bring out my Ryan Gosling blanket and everything while I watch it.
Yes. Well, he's very nice. Now, here's the thing. I own Oppenheimer on 4K, and Chauncey was kind enough to gift me, Sue and I, gift us a copy of Barbie, the Barbie movie.
Oh, it's so cool.
Barbie was good. I didn't think it was great. I thought Oppenheimer was great for the most part. Other than the tough wife role, they don't know how to write powerful roles for women anymore. There is an incredible film. I point to this many times. If you want to show female power, there is an old 1921 silent film called The Phantom Coach. It's part of the Criterion Collection. It's available on YouTube. And the women in that, the men are a bunch of misfits making bad decisions, like a true noir, bad decision after bad decision. And the women are the stable element that holds the whole culture together. And without those women, they are lost. They are lost. The women come out as vessels of integrity and honor. And
for that time period, that's surprising.
And will, oh, it's incredible. And it's a, but of course, it's a foreign film. I forget the country that originates in offhand, but it's very good. It's called The Phantom Carriage. And it's regarded so highly, and the restoration on it is astounding. So there you go. That's my recommendation, Phantom Carriage. Rob, you ever see that one? And did you test for it? 1921's The Phantom Carriage. And what did people say as they emerged from the theater, or perhaps a speakeasy?
Well, Rachel, yes, that's fascinating, because when the people came out, they went like this.
It was prior to talkies, but there, maybe there was a little piano accompaniment. Great acting, Rob. Fantastic. Okay, I love Joe. I'm just confused why he doesn't like me. It's more funny to me than anything. Well, Mikhail, that's a great attitude to have.
Because you have a weird name.
No, he doesn't. It's a beautiful name. That's a beautiful name. And the name's not weird. Okay? Let's get that straight. Okay. Wild Strawberry. Oh, boy. Okay. Anyway, work with Joe. Joe's a good man. Before the movie, I would say that. I was thinking so. Okay, people are talking about books versus a movie. Generally, Rob, let's go around the table. Book movie preference. Book movie.
Depends. It really depends. Oh, sorry.
We'll go, Rob, and then we'll come up. We're going to end.
They're literally, figuratively, two different things.
Yeah. They are two different things.
You can go more nuanced in a book, and you can't in a movie. They're two different things.
All right, so you can't even, it's comparing apples and oranges.
It's apples and oranges.
But you're not much of a reader, so I assume you're naturally
You're
probably going to go with a movie.
People who say they like the book more than the movie, fine with them, but they're two different things.
Adis, book or movie for you?
I mean, when you hear Quint delivering his USS Indianapolis speech in Jaws, yes. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
You can read it in a book, but you can't, you know, it's so different. So movies for me.
Okay, movie for Dave. Beetle Bay.
I like both. I like being able to compare the differences between the two, yeah, personally, especially because usually there's things that have been cut out from the book that never make it to the movie. And a lot of times those will change the entire story on certain ones. So I think they both have merit.
Okay, I think they both have merit. I much prefer the book over the movie when you want to get to what it is, you know, what the story is. Go ahead.
What about when they do those novelizations of movies when they're a hit and then they write a book based on the movie?
Yeah, I prefer the movie in that case, because the movie, the original source, right, primary source that we call it in the business. Now, here's an interesting thing. Because of the whole nature of movies and books and the whole presentation representation, boy, oh, boy. And this is a hot topic. Michael Nolan, The Bottom Line, great channel, good friend of this channel. Michael Nolan has just done an upload where he's talking about biopics. These rock and roll stories with Bohemian Rhapsody, Elvis, you know. They go on and on. Rocket Man, he doesn't like them. He says they're problematic. Rob, biopics, you're feeling...
Well, but because the nature that you legally and storytelling wise, can't get into a lot of stuff. They're they're partially fictionalized. So either a good movie is a good movie, a bad movie is a bad movie.
Yeah.
To have sort of a negative slant on just a genre of biopics seems odd. If the movie's good and it entertains you, then it's a good movie.
There's that, but they will never be 100% accurate ever.
Well, and I mean, that's usually.
Oh, I know that. But that is one beef that I've always had with them, and I find myself nitpicking them, even though I know the nature of the beast, it has to be that way. But some of them still ride the line better than others. Like Love and Mercy is a perfect example of this, of one that I thought was done a lot better. But then there's other ones, like, take your pick, any one of the Beatle ones that exist. I don't think they've ever been done well. The perfect example of them done badly. So
hopefully I can get Joe up. I want to talk about Michael Corey here. So Joe, here's the deal. I'm going to intercede on Michael's behalf for it, because, you know, I love Joe. Michael seems like a good guy. Do you know why you blocked him, Joe? Do you even remember? Sometimes these things happen, an off-the-cuff thing. Apparently, Michael is saying, and this may not even be true, but Michael's saying he was blocked. And so he seems like a decent guy. He's never acted out of hand or out of character here. He's a good kid. And so if you can see it clear to unblock him, that would be a great thing. Okay. Well, Joe goes, I don't even remember him. He doesn't recall what happened. Joe's a guy with, what has he got, 14,000, 15,000 followers. I mean, you know, it's going to be hard for him to remember everybody. It's a much more intimate, smaller thing here. So I kind of know everybody. Okay, the book is much better. So generally the book, I don't like biopics because if I follow into them, I can believe some of the biopic rhetoric, and then I go, oh, shit, that never happened. That was made up. Yeah, they needed it.
Okay,
hold on, Ringo. I prefer then to documentaries.
Okay, here's a curveball for you, Rachel. Yeah,
go ahead.
The movie The Rose with Bette Midler.
Yeah, never seen it.
But it's a fictionalized story influenced by... Influenced by what's her face?
Some say love, it is a flower.
Oh, no.
What, Rob? This is pretty good. He's pretty good, right?
You haven't seen the movie.
Some say love.
So there's plenty of movies that were made that were influenced by. There were plenty. Okay. There, yeah. Like that movie. Remember The Idolmaker? Did you ever see that movie?
Idolmaker. Let me think. What was in
Taylor Hackford? It was a fictionalized story about the development of all those teen idols back in the 50s, 60s. Uh-oh. What did I do? It's a Rob Walker.
Is it Rob Walker?
Because I said The Rose. But, I mean, Rachel, there are plenty of movies that are like that, that are influenced or based on the life of someone, you know, real.
Oh, wow. Okay. There's going to be a Bob Dylan biopic soon with Timothy Chalamet playing Bob Dylan, which is pretty good casting.
But Scorsese's doing it.
Wow. Do you know, there's a number of Bob Dylan treatments. I thought Hayden Christensen, the kid, the Darth, Vader, the Canadian kid, he played Bob Dylan in The Factory Girl, I believe, maybe. I think he did. He did good. And you know who's crazy good was the guy from Australia who played Andy Warhol. Andy, you know, he was so good, Rob.
Rachel, what about Bruno Ganz, who played you know who in the Downfall?
The Downfall.
Okay, about the final days in the bunker.
And then there's a million memes that were launched from it.
Yeah, but it's such a great actor in that movie. Yes. Biopic of sorts.
I know.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, look at this. No more biopics about musicians. Really cringe worthy crap. What do you think, Jen? Pro or con?
Honestly, I could be fine with if they never did another one personally, but that's just me.
Well, the Michael Jackson one's coming out, I think.
And I'll still watch it. I mean, as long as they keep making it, I'm still going to watch them. But I'm saying if it were up to me.
Okay, Michael goes, I figured Joe didn't mean to. I was confused and curious if I did something weird. Haha, thank you, Joe. So it seems like Joe will reinstate you. He doesn't even have any memory of any problems with you. But, you know, you have that kind of many people following you, watching, tuning in, doing stuff. It's easy for things to happen and get
lost. Hey, Rachel?
Yeah.
Rachel, can you play a Bob Dylan song so Louie has to hear it so his streak ends?
How does it feel to be on your own?
There's no chance in hell you haven't heard of Bob Dylan. There's no chance. His music's used in movies and TV commercials. There's no way you haven't heard a Bob Dylan song.
You used to talk so loud. Now you don't seem so proud. But have to be a scoundrel. Your next hit me up. How does it feel?
All right, Louie, that was for you. Adis, did you like that, Bob Dylan? Did that sound like you were in the
room? Yeah, it's a lot of emotion. Yes. Bring all of yourself to it. Uh-oh. You should do Lemmy.
Look what happened now. It's called a joke, Rob. This is kickback.
You haven't perfected that yet.
It's hurtful, Ian. Okay, now, Adis, I don't do Lemmy, but you do a really good Lemmy.
Ooh, let's hear it.
Okay, here he goes.
All right, I have to.
Okay, get your mic.
No, it's not the mic.
Okay, get your hat. Okay, here we go. Let me kill my stir.
We're a motorhead. We're going to get
yes.
I haven't done this for a long time.
That was like we were right there. We're a motorhead,
and we play rock and roll.
Oh, like that. Oh, okay. Now, what about this? Okay, what do you guys think about this Marvin Hamlisch biopic?
Oh, I didn't even know they were making one on him. All right, I'm interested. I'm interested.
Rachel, I'm making one, and I'm casting the Rev as Marvin Hamlisch.
Michael, I just want you and Joe to get back together because there's no real mean reason for you guys to be on the outs.
Oh, hold on, Rachel. Joe doesn't even know who the guy is.
I know. That's what I'm saying. We're trying to get him back together. Well, I see what you say. We can't get back together. Joe doesn't know who you are. Hey, did you guys see the latest Ice Castles Instagram thing from the Reverend? He told us about Ice Castles. This is a great, great album. But the thing is, I'm learning from him. You got to get the American pressing with all the proper engineers, Americans on it. It's Ice Castles the way the producers intended it to sound. Rob, I'm so grateful to you. So grateful to you. Because I have my very own copy of Ice Castles. Thanks to you. Have you since picked up a recovery copy for yourself so that the album is still in your collection?
No.
I can't believe you'd let it go like that. Because, I mean, I'm obviously... Well,
you know why I don't do it, Rachel? Because I found out Ice Castles is based on a true story.
Okay, Jim Morrison's Lizard asked a question so many are interested in. Is there anywhere we can see Beetle Babe's collection?
No, I don't show my collection online. I'm paranoid like that.
Oh, okay.
You know, after you get robbed once, you kind of don't want to invite trouble a second time.
Okay, so you showed your collection once you got in trouble?
No, I never did, but especially after that, I'm like, I'm really, really not doing it now.
Okay, now you made her gun shy. That's
well,
okay.
Not you specifically, but the dude who did it. So
that, listen, dude, but the whole point is we got so much. Thanks, Rachel. I do want to get back together with Joe, even if it's a one-sided relationship. Rob, there you go. That's your answer.
There's a diagnosis we can make for you, Mikhail Corey. Do you live in a world of fan fiction?
Fan fiction with Joe. Deese, have you ever been involved with any sort of fan fiction? Have you, in an off-guarded moment, gotten involved?
I've read some Kraftwerk fan fiction and they were having sex with each other, so I just signed off.
Really? So it does exist? I'd heard rumors.
Yeah, I don't want to read it.
Deese, how did you find my writings?
Okay, what's Hovis doing? That's what maintaining your smug out of it. He's not Harvest, be good boy. Don't be like a bad Grinch. Okay, Oscar the Grouch. Good God. Okay, Remus is here. Okay, well, Rob, this is obviously for you to read.
Morning, human beings and degenerates. The degenerates know who they are. Just popping in to say zippity doo dah. Everyone have a great day.
Oh my God, I love it.
Mr. Race's birdie on my shoulder.
Just horrible. Okay, JB, what's wrong? Now, is it because I yelled at you earlier in the program that you got hurt and you're not recovered, JB? JB, you're a fine member, upstanding member of the community. You're doing good. JB, what would you like me to do for you? What would up the show's value for you? Okay. Let's try it, because you want me to show you a record of a band you like or something? Is with that whatever pleases you, I'll do it, you know. Or okay, I won't do anything at all. You know, I just want to please you, whatever it is, you know. Okay. What? You must enjoy being angry because this is too funny. It's just boring. What do you mean it's boring? We got a great cast. Deez is here bringing heat from Israel. We got Rob, who's on the top of his game. And we got beautiful Jen, who's a real girl with real girl feelings and everything. And, of course, I'm here the way as usual. I enjoyed Rob's Yogi Bear impression. Do you do a Yogi Bear?
No, that was okay,
I'll help you with Yogi.
I was going to say, that was Song of the South. That wasn't Yogi Bear.
Yeah, he was doing Song of the South. Okay, it's a variety.
Vivian, are you thinking of picnic baskets?
Okay, we got to go into, let's go into an area we don't do a lot of. Do you want some classical talk? Do you want some classical records showing, JP? Do you like Baroque? Are you big on Baroque? God, you know, JP, I'm trying to do the best I can for you.
But wait.
Uh-oh, Joe's on the house with Herc. Boo-hoo, Herc. Uh-oh. This is some Rachel for your enjoyment. Jack Kirby's daughter has got a 60s band, Jack Kirby, the King of Comics, co-creator of the Fantastic Four, Iron Man, Captain America, so many incredible heroes, the Mighty Thor. How many records on everyone's shelves? Pull the mofos out. Oh, JB, how many? Oh my God, so you should ask me to carry that. Oh my God. She got a big box full of logs and stuff. Now, listen this. I got tons of records back there, man. You know? And then, there, like I say, you know I got tons there. And this thing right here is filled with compact discs. I got tons of them. Look. How many people are promoting Robin Thicke compact discs?
Oh, wow.
It's even
yeah, got, you got a point.
Yeah, it's got the parental advisory on it.
Was that Blurred Lines?
It's called Blurred Lines.
Yep.
It seems to be very popular with young people.
I think it came out like 10 years ago. And yeah. I can't believe it's been 10 years already.
So we got that. Okay. Oh, Stendi, you're not a fan of my video on signing and personalizing your records in 2024? Signing and personalizing records. This is something that the wonderful Fred Putterman, vinyl community member, Frederick Putterman did. We shouldn't be too precious with our vinyls, you know. Okay, JB's right, Rich. This show is a smorgasbord of content covering the same old ground. Records, music, community of the vinyl okay. community. Maybe we should branch out. Well, what do you want us to do? Talk cars?
Rich, I'll show a record that might have a
1960 Chevy Impala, an incredible automobile. Okay, right.
Here's a record that tell me how this connects to you, because I think it does.
Okay. Ahmad Jamal. This is one of Sue's favorite. Oil Canaries.
Yeah.
Isn't he the guy that tied up Bullwinkle or something?
No, it was a club in Vancouver. Oh, okay. Silly Willie.
All right.
So it was a club in Vancouver. That's where this was recorded at Oil Canaries. Okay. There you go, JB. A record. See how it was accepted here?
Yeah. Okay. Now, are you happy? And it's probably a record you don't even have. Hi, AGK. There's more than one son of a bitch here also. Just saying. Hi, Scotty. Welcome to the show. We got a good show. Man. We got a lot of music. Listen, Alex Cooper, Billion Dollars Babies is just days away from getting here. Tomorrow or today.
That was Oil Can Boyd.
Yeah, that was Oil Can Boyd. He's showing up. Okay, I'm going to check the status of my order now for you. Okay, this is a guy arriving tomorrow by 10 o'clock. Liam Gallagher, John Squire, Amazon exclusive Orange Eco record.
What's an Eco record?
That's a mistake. I shouldn't have bought that one.
No.
But, oh, well, that's what, because it's going to disintegrate. It'll play maybe 5 minutes.
Gotcha.
And then it'll probably biodegrade on me. That's horrible. Sue, the thing is going to... Okay. That's horrible. Okay? That's horrible, Rishi. Don't talk about my post. Okay? Girls can get... We're not just body parts, you awful man. We're living souls with feelings. And we're smart. And we can do shit. Okay, I'm starting a petition. I demand change. We're going to have a whole Manchester discussion of football in England. Deese, do you have a favorite English football Premier League team?
I used to like Tottenham.
Tottenham?
Yeah.
Yeah, so Tottenham Hotspur.
Hotspurs, yeah.
Jen, favorite English Premier Division football club?
I don't watch
sports.
That's because you have a girl brain. Rob, famous Premier Division football club.
Arsenal, because it sounds like asshole.
Good answer.
Oh, it's horrible. Of course, I'm Everton Blue. Everton Blue. Okay, you want to talk about the Jam, Paul Weller, and the boys?
He has a new album coming out.
Okay. Liz Taylor was amazing in the...
Yes, she was. That's actually my favorite movie of hers.
Oh, my God. And it's got... Who's the gal? Sandy? Sandy is
Sandy
in there.
Sandy Duncan, I think? No.
Sandy Dennis. No. Sandy Dennis.
Sandy Dennis. Sandy Dennis.
Sandy Dennis. And who's the other guy? I liked him. He's gone now. We launched him.
Oh, gosh.
He was handsome. George Segal.
Yes.
George Segal's in that. And of course, the great, the incredible, the Welsh actor Richard Burton.
Yes.
Dick and Liz.
Two-time husband of Liz.
Okay. Kristen knows a lot about Premier First Division football. Says it means Rob and Deese must fight Arsenal versus Spurs. Choose your weapons, gentlemen.
I'm a lover, not a fighter.
He's a lover.
I'm a fighter, and I'd rather fight Chris.
Okay, 66 is out the day before Weller's 66. Well, that's incredible because Weller and I are the same age. I'm 66, too. I'm very elderly.
Isn't it amazing? The same year two people were born.
I'm very elderly.
One vastly talented, the other not so much.
Sandy Dennis, thank you, Scotty. Okay, Bruce Dickinson has a new album, sound as good as the late Iron Maiden record. Now, that's really interesting, Jason, because we had that album showing, I believe, yesterday on yesterday's program. Discussed. Who brought that up? It was maybe Thor had it. One of our kids had it. Okay. 60 isn't really that old nowadays, says Henry.
Yes, it is.
And I can see why Joe Mayo doesn't like, you're the wrong guy. Never mind.
AJK, you're so smart if you're being hit. I'm apparently a source of material for Ray the last few weeks, daily basis, doing live streams about me. I won't give him any traction viewing any of it.
Definitely.
Well, you just mentioned it just now.
I'm going over there to watch now because I'm all excited about the new series that he's put together about you, AGK.
He's more aimed at me than at AGK.
Yes, Rachel is telling, thank you. One of our friends had the computer open. Well, I heard a voice like a, was it for a tannoy? Have you heard of these things? They're called tannoys. They had those on the MASH 401.
I'm not sure what a tannoy is.
Okay, I love this. This is our next topic. We're going to be talking fish vinyl community. I'll do my best Bobby Gass I can do, given that it's a Monday. Yeah, I like to talk fish, Chance. I love that. Wow, you look so young, Frank. Rachel, can you please play the Invisible Ray videos about AGK? I'm asking for
please don't.
No, we aren't going to do that. Oh, Ray makes a cameo in my latest film, Sweating to the Trolleys.
Mm.
Okay.
Well, hey, Rachel, can I say something?
Can we do a promotion, please?
Yes. Rice Paddies Jr., talented beyond belief, beyond compare, has such a great tinge on what's the pulse of what's going on, social commentary, artistic integrity.
Yes.
The craftsmanship that goes into each video. Yeah. The sound effects, the pacing, just everything about it. It's a pleasure to even remotely know Rice Paddies Jr.
I love that. That is the kind of, that's the kind of endorsement we have. It's the official parody channel of the Rachel's Ghost program, and it's fantastic. We've embraced him so strongly. I hope you're subscribed to Tight Fonchi Pod. Tight Fonchi, can you put a link to your channel? So Jen can subscribe.
Yeah, let's see.
Okay, it sounded a bit like the Exorcist voice. It can, for God. Okay. Okay, Stendy, that's just crazy talk. Time for 106. No, we're doing good. Okay. Oh, Frank says he's been very physically happy. I love Curb Your Enthusiasm. We all do. Okay. With the demise of Marius Stark, I'm filling a void, says Rice Paddies Jr. Hi, Bip. Welcome to the show. Okay. 60 is definitely the new 50, but it's still closer to 80. Boy, is that true. You know, you're closing in. All our heroes are getting older. We were talking about Bill Shatner earlier in the program. That guy is in his 90s now. I mean, it's hard to believe.
Okay, just subscribe to Rice Paddies Jr.
Holy smokes. Well, Jason says the first season of this show was probably the best. Hey, we just have fun, man. We talk about different things, whatever's there. I'm just waiting. I have a lot of records in my collection. I talk about any band you want. You know, there's a lot of band. The Jam was mentioned. Power Trio coming out of the punk movement. That was
it's just mainly Paul Weller, right?
He's a guy, Bruce Fox, something Bruce Fox Club or Foxworthy, something like it. He's the bass player's really good. I like him. And Foxton, is it? I don't know. But, you know, Paul's the main guy. But they had a good look. They wore the suits, so they were a lean-looking machine. They look really good. And so Bruce Foxton, thank you. And he was really good, you know, and I liked his stuff too. So the Jam's a great band. I've got one Jam album in the collection, but I also have the box set, Jam 5 CD box set, tall box, very nice to have. Bring back Beetlejuice. Well, that was all a falling out with James. And first of all, of course, Jen can't, because James started having eyes for Jen, and that became awkward. Well, yeah, it gets, because some of these guys, they don't know how to act around a girl.
I didn't even know about some of the things he was saying on other people's streams referring to me. I had other people telling me about it. Then I went and looked. I was like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, no. No. Had to put the kibosh on that fast.
Well, yeah, because they're trying to. Of course, he's so much older than you, and that's one of the problems. Sir James hit multiple times. He is a nice guy. Henry is a nice guy. Yes, he's a very nice guy. The problem is that the poor boy does have proclivities. Okay. So there is that. So just be careful, especially if you're a child. I wouldn't have my kids around, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah, that.
Okay. Link for David. We can do that. Hang on there. There it is. There's a link for David. Come on up, David. Is that what you mean? I think he just mean give David a link for his channel. Have you seen Phantom of the Paradise at Brayston? I've seen it. Years ago, Paul Williams, standout in that one. Very good show. Jen, have you seen Phantom of the Paradise?
No, I've never even heard of that.
It's a rock and roll musical based on Phantom of the Opera.
Ooh.
It was around 1974. Okay, now, hold on. I got to prepare you for David. There he is. Be prepared. Steel yourselves. David, you're not looking as healthy or as strong as we have seen you in previous episodes.
I know. I just wanted to say thanks because there's loads of people in the peanut gallery sort of saying thanks, you know, saying hope you know get better and stuff. And it's I've just been in the wars, you know.
Yeah. Now, so you just had surgery. Was it surgery or was it a checkup or a setback?
They had to take something that looked quite nasty out of my arm.
Oh, okay.
And so I. You know, like last time I couldn't play drums for ages and now guitar and bass is out of the question.
Yeah, because that's obviously your working arm.
Yeah. And it's like last time I did, it was that doing that Stereophonics gig. And in this, we were in this huge amphitheater. And on the last song, I tore my rotator cuff.
Oh, no.
And it's I did the last song one-handed, which was pretty cool. But no, I just want to. I'm not going to hang around because I'm probably quite boring, and I'm kind
of. No, you're not. We love you, David.
Three sheets to the fucking wind at the moment.
Yeah. Okay, I understand. So they've given you a number of pain medications to take care of things.
Yes. Yeah. I'm all sorted on that score. It's just the really sort of obviously most of you know that you know I make my living by hitting things or striking strings, you know, and. It's I'm all right, by the way. There's no GoFundMe, don't worry. I've got savings. it's a pain, isn't it? You know, it's just and I like it, you know, it's what I do for fun and work. So I'm loving the street. Honestly, it's been so nice to be able to just sit and watch everyone chatting and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, it's just friends hanging out, having a good time.
Yeah, I really felt good because I think a lot of people, my social circle in Norwich where I live is really small. Yeah. And it's because when you go on tour over about, say, 20 years, you know, people get married, people move away, people this, that and the other. And I come home and it's fine, but I've got a very, very small sort of bunch of friends that, you know, maybe four or five. There's a lot of people I know, but not people you'd really, you know, you rely on have a cup of tea with and all that sort of stuff, you know. And so having you guys today and over the last few days and all the times that it's, you know, it's been a bit difficult over the last little while, it's very much appreciated.
Really. Well, we appreciate you, David, for one thing. And we just want you to get back on your feet and feeling 100% and, you know, get that strength built up. And whatever the core problem is, get that fixed and get you right back.
Absolutely. Good to see another lady on here as well.
Yes, I got Jen with us.
Absolutely. I mean, I'm doing my best.
Oh, hello. I know. Holy smoke. Rob has asked me to get him a shirt of that only with me. And I said I refuse to paint. I refuse to photograph myself just for his amusements.
I think these are Susie Sue's, actually, if I remember.
Oh, Susie Sue. Correctly. Yeah, Susie and Banshee. Fantastic.
I believe so, yeah.
All right, we got a question here. This is a little bit of drama that we got to deal with. Rachel has been falling out with the Rice Patties. Apart from being a douche in comment sections, seems like a pleasant enough guy. I think he is, Herc, a pleasant enough guy. I'm going to, you can put a quote, patty cakes or vinyl patties, whatever. Anyway, Rice Patties guy, he's a pleasant guy. But the problem is he's a passive aggressive type. And so there was initially a falling out with Rob. And then he would go around and he would contact various people have talked to me saying, yeah, the guy did this. And you hear little echoings where the guy's leaving comments on other people's live streams, other people's private messaging. It just got a little strange, a little out there. Rob, response?
He is what I would call someone who has delusions of grandeur. He thought he could do all this better than anyone else. And that he didn't understand that people actually have to like you to be successful at this. So He's seeing the result of it.
Yeah, it's like a lower
now, he's found a bunch of other butthurt people that he can surround himself with and have a good old time.
Yeah. Now,
Records?
Yes. The ill-conceived names should say it all to everybody.
Yeah.
Wax. Okay. I've got something for. I've just got something for Wax before I go, okay. And then I'll leave.
Go ahead, David.
You might appreciate this, Wax. The singer from the band Peaceful Cacophony, Denise, she gave me a lift back from hospital yesterday because obviously I wasn't allowed to drive. And she gave me a lift back, and I started watching Rachel's Ghost straight away. And you and Mazzy were on the top line, and you were on the left. Mazzy was on the right, I think. And she said, is that guy on the right the guy on the left's dad?
Yes, absolutely. And
here would be the good response. All American Jews look alike.
Oh, my God. That is so funny.
All right. Take care, everybody. Thank you so much.
Bless you.
Get well soon.
I'll be back on it and rocking soon, I'm sure.
All right, David. Be well. Be well.
All right. Love you all.
David Donnelly, folks. Love him. Bye, David. Okay, now, next question. Honestly, I wish you wouldn't bash James. Listen, we're not bashing him. We're just saying the question is raised in a public forum, and I am publicly discussing the publicly responded situation to the whole thing. It's all part of the public record. And nobody's bashing the guy. I'm just saying this is good. And if the best you come up with, his streams are giving him focus, please leave certain things... Yeah, if the guy had the cops sting him with an undercover cop because he's trying to pick up a 12-year-old, that's his business. But I'm telling you one thing, HBK. Oh, it's just giving him focus. So as long as he's got focus, he's not going to go hustle down a 12-year-old?
I heard it was a 15-year-old.
Yeah, it was an undercover cop, whatever the hell it was. I mean, who knows what the hell she passed herself off as. Okay.
Oh, hold on one second. AGK, I just want to point something out. If you didn't mention it, Rachel wouldn't have gone on that tirade.
Yeah. Now you got me lit up.
So
yeah.
The point is you don't have to mention people who bash you. Then we wouldn't talk about it.
Yeah. Oh my God. Okay, now. Is a great superstar. David Donnelly is a great panelist. Indeed he is.
Even with half his energy.
It's long past, leave past in the past.
Yes.
As long as it's focused, it's in the past. Is that what you're telling me, HK? Because that's how I fucking read that. Holy shit. I can't believe the comment. Just leave it. So, he's focused now. Just leave him focused. He won't be jumping on 12-year-olds. For God's sakes, man. HK, you are your own worst enemy. There's some truth in that. Don't get Rachel lit up. Okay, now are you happy, JP? Yeah, you wanted some action. Holy smokes. Oh, my God. You know what's funny? You get these things. I just got an email from the McAfee people, McAfee antivirus. They come packed on your computer because computers make deals with all these third-party computer things, so they throw them on. And then they become a thing. And it's just crazy. So it's just awful. It was nothing. It's all in the past. It's all in the past. Okay, we're just leaving it alone there. Okay. James looks like Christopher Walken. Yes, very dashing. A couple of them. Okay, this is an interesting link. This is breaking news. A new manga series for Little Mermaid.
Let's see.
She's become a lesbian and a couple with another mermaid. It's called Sinner of the Deep Sea Manga.
I'm not paying $41 for that. If you had my interest for half a second there.
We got more problems. We got more problems now. Look, we all know. Rob, can you read this? I'm just letting you. I'm throwing this to you. I'm throwing you the wolves.
Blah, 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 blah.
Well read. Holy smokes. Okay, the manga is 178 pages of fun. Okay, Beetle Babe is mostly a CD collector. She's, yeah. And she's a Beetle fan, and she's explained this earlier in the program. Boy, oh boy. Now, Deese, have you ever encountered any trouble in your life with friends or somebody with proclivities?
With what?
Yes.
I'm sorry, it's not my mother language.
Okay.
It's do we have to spell it out?
Yeah, we're not going to do
that. Repeat the question. Right.
Hold on, Deese.
Rob,
go Meshuggah. There you go. Thank you.
Meshuggah. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sorry. But I want some. It's okay. You're all here. The show's happening. It's going on. Folks, I got Alice Cooper coming. Billion Dollar Babies this Friday. Tomorrow, it's the latest combination. Liam Gallagher with John Squire, late of the Stone Roses there over in the UK. So, you know, it's a good album.
Is there any samplings of the music?
Yeah, there's full videos.
What does it sound like? It
sounds like rock. It sounds really good. Yeah, it sounds really good.
Is it Oasis-ish?
Oh, no, it's not Oasis-ish. Only in so much as Liam vocal, so yeah. You recognize that vocal. But the music, no, it's rock. It's rock and roll, pure rock and roll. It's just so good. And I've heard the two songs off of it, and I like them both, so
it's just their names. They don't have a band name, right?
No, it's just, it's just Liam Gallagher and John Squire. I think I don't know if they're calling it anything. Okay, Rach, I am loving it. I got it with the exact two, moving magnet. That's the same one I'm rocking. I took it's almost like the default cartridge for it, and it's a beautiful sounding turntable. Rach, do you know Danny Ambrosi? Has he ever been up here? Is Danny, Danny is, I do know him. But I only know him through Joe's show. I haven't had him up. I haven't had the pleasure of having him on. But him and Joe are friends. He's a regular on the Joe Mail show. And I enjoy him. He seems like a very nice lad. And Joe enjoys him. Okay, I love this. Sparkly curtains, wood paneling is a match made in heaven. So, Jen, you're really knocking it out of the park.
That's not even wood paneling. That's a record player.
Oh. Look at this. We got problems. Let's go to Rob with this.
Wait, can you clarify? Are you in a pool to be part of a jury, or are you on trial for something? Like the condemned ski lodge for putting people at risk with lead in the water and shit like that.
Yes.
Thank you,
Stephen, for that encouragement. Now we've got this problem. I'm going to let Deese read this one.
Nick Pantazzi?
Yeah, Pantazzi. You can say Pantazzi. Yeah.
Good morning, Rach and Sue. Hey, Rob, Deese, and a real girl, Beetle Babe. I hope the boys that have never seen a girl are behaving.
They're behaving.
Hey, Rachel, yeah. I caught a bit of the George Borden stream last night. And
okay, George was rocking it.
I believe that him and Nick were picking and grinning.
Oh, were they both playing guitars and stuff?
Yeah, but I couldn't figure out which one was picking.
And who was grinning. Anyone like the UK group called the Mock Turtles, Beatles-sounding group? Frank, I don't know the band myself.
I don't either.
Rob, Mock Turtles, have you heard of them?
Is that the Rice Paddies band?
I don't know, man. It's something I'm not familiar with. Okay, I'm going to have a show. Okay, Rich, I have a great show idea. I'm putting on my vision board. Wax, Rice, and Schnee have a show together. Sounds like a rabbi, a priest.
No, Rachel, this is fan fiction.
This is fan fiction, Herc. Come on now. I like the Stone Roses and all, but I'm not sure that album would make my top 20 of 89, the debut album. Times a great manga up there. Monster Madness, comics adaptations, H.P. Lovecraft. Okay, in my opinion, the band sounds closest to the Beatles or the Hollies. What is it, Knickerbockers? They had their hit that.
How do the Hollies even sound remotely like the Beatles?
Yeah, I was just like, I'm not entirely sure where he's going with this. Just because they are 60s band.
Look at the harmonies they have.
Badfinger, ELO, so many other bands emulated the Beatles.
You could at least make an argument for those two. Especially Badfinger. I mean, yeah, I think they sound Beatly. ELO, it's not so much that they sound Beatly in and of their music itself, but you can tell the influence of where it comes through almost like spiritually in the music.
The air that I breathe sounds nothing like the Beatles. Nothing.
No.
Zero like the Beatles.
Mm-mm. Hard disagree. Nope.
You can make other bands that sounds like, but not the Beatles. I guess Clack too. Yeah. There's tons of bands. Not the Hollies.
The one I always think of is the Bee Gees. Lonely Days, Lonely Nights sounds like Lennon. I'm having a good little piece of that.
I'm not talking about any Hollies. He mentioned the air that I breathe.
Do you think the Beatles would have gone disco if they continued into the 70s?
Well, no. There's a proof why they haven't. Because each individual Beatle would have gone disco.
I think Ringo did for like half a second there on, what was it, Ringo the Fourth? But it did not go well for him. He never did it again. So,
I mean, none of the Beatles even remotely touched it, right? I mean, I guess I don't know about the Ringo stuff, but...
The other three, yeah. I don't think any of the other three did.
Denise, read that one.
Nathaniel Marsh, the band that sounds most like the Beatles is probably one of those touring cover bands that plays Beatles sets at, like, dinner theaters.
That's a genius comment, Nathaniel Marsh. Really, how long did it take you to come up with that one? I don't think so. I mean, I don't. Can you make a case because Graham Nash was in the...
Hey, Mr. Mayo says, Air That I Breathe chorus sounds Beatly harmony.
But can you make a case that it also sounds like Crosby, Stills, and Nash because Graham Nash was in it and he was a harmony guy? No?
Yeah, but that's not disco for Listening What the Man Said.
Yeah, I mean, it has a little beaty to it.
I mean, a lot of his stuff in the 70s had like a beat to it. I mean, you could say that about silly love songs. It doesn't make it disco.
Hey, Rachel, you were in the disco scene. Did you ever hear a Paul McCartney song in the discos?
No.
Wow.
I can't hear this through your horse mask. Sorry.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, but that also wasn't Beatles.
Are you talking about from the movie Fame?
That's a horrible song.
Oh, wait, no. They mean David Bowie's because technically Lennon was on it. All right, fine. You technically found one loophole to it. All right.
Coming up is
I don't know. Yeah, but
I would call that disco exactly. I'm not sure what I'd call it, but not disco.
No. There's one way to maybe solve it is let's see what the internet says. Okay.
Lennon did hang out at 54, but so did Ringo for that matter. Black Knight was issued as a disco single.
Someone mixed a disco version of Beatles songs.
Yeah, I've heard those.
Okay. Lonely Days, Lonely Nights. This is the Lonely Days, Lonely Nights. We're going to risk playing it. Bee Gees. Okay. And I'll tell you, it's the Bee Gees doing the Beatles with this song. Okay, Bailey, what's this? I guess this will probably be okay today. Yeah, it's from the Bee Gees official. So let's see how it. You tell me, and I'll let it go along a bit until it goes, because it builds up. Okay. Oh yeah. Okay. 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 Oh man. Okay. So I'm just cutting in a little bit in the middle of it, and this is the Bee Gees trying to do the Beatles sound. You tell me if I'm right. Here we go.
Lonely days, lonely nights.
Okay.
Where would I be without my woman? Lonely days, lonely nights. Where would I be without my woman? Lonely days, lonely nights. Lonely days, lonely nights. Where would I be without my woman? Brighten up my day. Come sit beside me in your
Here comes Selena.
Lonely days, lonely nights. Where would I be without my woman? Lonely days, lonely nights. Where would I be without my woman? Lonely days.
So there you go. I mean, you got the idea, right?
I know, sounds like about you could make the same argument for a bunch of other bands that it sounds like simultaneously too.
Well, here's why I say it, because the Bee Gees have their own sound, and that's the Bee Gees departing from their normal sound, and that's purposely great. Kind of they got the horns, the brass, so they've got the Penny Lane vibe there. You've got the screaming John Lennon. Lonely days, lonely night. He's got all the drag at the back of the vocals. That's not the way they normally would sing. The Bee Gees had their own sound. You think of I Started a Joke.
I know.
Was that the 1910 or whatever mining town disaster, Massachusetts? Massachusetts. So they had their own sound. I think that was a departure. It's an early 70s thing. And I think it was kind of the last thing they came out with before they went disco, and that revived them. But I think they were running a little thin of ideas by that time. And so it's a nice panache. It's a send up, but all the tropes, the Beatle tropes, are all present in that song. I can see it as a Beatles fan. It's certainly evident to me, but you know, your opinions may differ, but that's the rationale, Chan.
An interesting choice that they made Robin the main focus of that video. I'm like, wasn't he kind of like the funniest looking one? I'm like, why wouldn't you use, I don't know, Barry as the main one?
Yeah, for a term. So who was there? Normally, I guess it could have been some sort of, I don't know what the thinking was behind the video. I don't know much of the story behind it, but it's from the official Bee Gees release. I love the Bee Gees first album. The first 45 I ever owned, 1971, first adult Big People's record I ever bought was a 45. I Started a Joke, the wonderful Robin Gibb doing the vocals on that thing. What a tear in your eye that thing is. You know, I Started a Joke, we started the whole world laughing. But anyway, I think that's the thing. The Beatles should have gone disco. I'm glad they didn't. The Beatles tended to avoid it more. Like, you've got John Lennon. Of course, Lennon goes so early. And he takes a big five-year break from 75 to 80, right when disco's kind of having its great He's house husbanding it. So Paul's still in the trenches during that period of time, throwing out albums. But, you know, listen to what your man said. And some of the songs mentioned earlier, keep in mind, Paul always enamored of the big band sounds that his father had brought to him. So he loves that band sound. That's how trumpets are usually used with him. And also when he does, like, listen to what you, the man said, there's no doubt where the influence is coming there. It starts out with, hey, man, how you doing? Good to see you. All right, welcome to New Orleans band. Yeah, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, soldier boy, kisses girl, leaves behind a magic world, tragic world. But anyway, you know, it's so, it's New Orleans is where the influence is coming from with that one, right? Kind of pretty obvious up front. Bronski Beat, first album, that's some great disco. I have that album, Small Town Boy, I love that song. Age of Consent is really great.
Yeah.
Lennon was ahead of his time, always the new stuff coming up. He said he liked reggae in 75. Yeah, but reggae is already well established going, but I see what you're saying in terms of the wider population embracing it, getting into it. Lennon liked to shit all over the Hollies, therefore the Hollies are greater than Lennon. He didn't like to shit all over them. I think there were different comments made at the time. Somebody's got a microphone in your face, and people just would say what they thought at any given time. Certainly the Hollies were not first and foremost every interview. I don't know. Have you asked, you know, Steve, you know, Graham Nash about what's happening? You know, Alan Clark, ask him. You know, it's not, you don't have it. Lennon talked very little about other bands. I think in music or something, or if he's trying to explain the music scene of the day, he could be quite disparaging, but that's just Lennon. Lennon liked the yellow. He says that's what they're us as to what we would have become if we had continued on. But it's a dismissive comment.
Well, ELO had disco songs, right?
They did.
Yeah, they did, yeah. But Lennon was very dismissive that way. What we would have, John, they're what you would have become in 67. You guys already put together White Album. White Album is no ELO. Neither is Get Back album, Let It Be. None of that is part of that. Kiss jumped on it. The Rolling Stones jumped on it. But yeah, for the most part, the Beatles just, they didn't go that route. For the most part, you know, you can say there's elements of it here and there, but certainly not in Lennon always said, I'm an old rock and roller. I'm looking back. He always looks back to Jerry Lee Lewis and Chuck Berry and those cats, right? ELO, so great. They are great. I've got a great box set on compact disc that's available. I got a few of them, their albums on vinyl. Back in 73, I had Roll Over Beethoven, a 45 of that. The White Album is a masterpiece. One of the great albums. I mean, the Beatles did so many. Here's the thing. Back in the 70s, when we had so little money as kids, you know, some of us are lucky enough to have a paper route or whatever. And so you have precious little money. And if you bought an album and you only had one or two songs you liked on it, you felt ripped off because you go, oh, yeah, I'm going to burn the needle out playing the tracks I like over and over. This is the way I thought as a kid. And so I'd feel ripped off. The good albums, a good album would be if you had an album with three songs on it. Then came the Beatles. I like that song. I like that song. I like that song. I like that song. Holy crap, flip it over. I like that song. I like that. There was no doubt about it. Every single song I liked. And then I discovered Yes, my second favorite band. I play that big, long, complex composition. So I go, holy crap, that 20 minutes, I like that whole thing. That was amazing. I got to hear it again today. And then Led Zeppelin. I like that song. I like that song. I like that song. My third favorite band. Pink Floyd. Same thing. You put on the whole album. You just go, my God. Are they good? David Bowie. Pinups. Aladdin Sane. Fantastic. Ziggy Stardust, right? Great album. Hunky Dory. So, ELO were very vocal about Discovery. I've got a copy of that album. Being the Disco Stab, the album title was formed from Disco Very. Yeah, Disco Very, Discovery. Randy Newman's song, Story of Rock and Roll Band, fits my view of ELO, says Raji. Very interesting band. I was on somebody show, but maybe it was my own. I don't know. Somebody was talking about the move. Oh, it was yesterday with Deese and Malachi. Was talking about the move. We had to talk about the move, and then the move evolving into ELO. Mm-hmm. And the ELO are great. Yeah, Beatles, Queen, Floyd, Stones, Fleetwood Mac, all bands. Of course, Fleetwood Mac changed so much. So you got the Peter Green, you got the Bob Welch periods with Fleetwood Mac. So they evolved a lot. And of course, Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham. Tears for Fears, Hurting the First to Grab Me Like That. For Fears, the Hurting, the First to Grab Me Like That.
It was an album. Yeah.
Great. I got Songs from the Big Chair, whatever it is. I got that.
Yeah.
Was that, you know, shout, let it all out. Again, with Dr. Jacob Janoff, David Janoff, Jacob Janoff, yeah, it's Jacob, with his Primal Scream therapy that one of the boys was, you know, doing at that time. Okay, well, you think about, John Lennon was scheduled to meet up with Debbie Harry. It worked, maybe it wouldn't. It's hard to say. Some artists meld together very effectively and others don't. BB Thel, can you tell me about Jimmy Barnes? I've had to unsub from him. I'm getting shit from him. I'm catching flack. What's going on?
I don't know anything about that guy. All I know is that you told me that he was okay, and I just saw him sitting all over you. So I was like going, all right, whatever.
So this is, it seems to be, but it's almost like he's got the runs. It seems like multiple shittings on me, Patrick. It's not just like one good, I got it out of my system. I had to leave a big dump on Rachel. It's like he's got some sort of diuretic condition of the diarrhea, and it's just free flowing. It's just splattering all over me on a continual basis.
So I had so you know, you have your feed, and occasionally, you know, something comes up and you click on it. So yesterday, Doc is, I guess, was having a stream, and Joe Mayo was on there. And I clicked on there for a second just to see what was happening. And Joe Mayo said something that I found very, that just struck me as like correct. You know, he just kind of said, you know, there's a group of like 5, 6, 7 people that just go around the streams high-fiving each other, saying, you know, mean shit about people. And, you know, and that's their vinyl community, you know.
Hey, Patrick, I said that a long time ago.
Hold on, Rob. Didn't do it as good as Patrick. Patrick, keep going. You're doing it way better than Rob. You did good though, Rob. But Patrick's really, I mean, he's in the pocket. Go ahead.
You know, so I mean, everyone always tries to say, you know, well, there's this VC UK, there's this VC, you know, I mean, there's vinyl community channels that I've never even seen. And they have their own version of what they consider the vinyl community to be. What Dale and Dave the Pickup Artist and those guys have, that's their vinyl community. It's not my vinyl community. My vinyl community are people that I subscribe to, people I hang out with. And it's not, there's no one single vinyl community. It's what you make of it and where you are. So they can have their own vinyl community. That's their thing. And, you know, so whatever they do, you know, let them do it. I don't care. You know, I'm just not going to hang out with them.
I love this comment from Richie. I was lost when Wax said it, but Patrick is really bringing the clarity. Thank you, Patrick, for
hold on. Good. Rachel, let me help.
Well, Rob was probably yelling when he said it.
Well, let me help him. Do you understand that?
I have bigger fish to fry than freaking Jimmy Barnes. So.
Okay, what's going on with you? Hold on. Who's frying your bacon?
Well, I mean, I was on, what was it, the Steve Westman stream on Friday, which is like it's an audiophile thing where we talk about, you know, stuff that a lot of people really hate. Yeah. But, you know, so we were having a subject was like budget audiophile records, good sounding records you can get for cheap.
This is the University of Vinyl's bread and butter. Tim does that all the time.
So Steve asked me beforehand, he said, hey, you know, do you think that the Ambrosia's first album would sell as a Rhino High Fidelity? Because they're thinking about making that Ambrosia album a Rhino High Fidelity title. And I said, well, I love that record. But, you know, I mean, there was some backlash, you know, after that record when they had that one sappy hit, That's How Much I Feel, you know?
Yeah.
So I said, you know, I love that record, but I don't know. But he asked me, would it sell? And I said, this on the stream, you know, there's a lot of blowback after they made that hit, but I love that record. That's what I said. And so after the stream, I was looking through the comments, and this guy goes, basically said, Patrick, you're a dick for saying that. You know, I mean, you know, you're bullying people. And like all I did was say that there was
why was 45 so upset with you?
No, not 45.
Oh, sorry. Wait
a minute. Whoa. Don't do that.
Michael,
don't Rachel explain. Don't Rachel explain and try to cause drama.
I'm so sorry. I'm teasing. Okay,
that's why Jimmy Barnes goes off on you.
For the love of God.
Yeah.
Okay, who was the guy that shit on you? Who said
that? I don't know who he is. I have no idea who he is. So I've never heard of him. But it was just kind of funny.
You are an unheard of person. You should be ashamed of yourself. Patrick is much loved. He's a great guy. Friendly.
It was funny.
Generous to a fault.
But you know, and I say this whenever I'm on my live stream with like Bit Bop Boom and stuff. I mean, it's like we argue about bands and say, you know, oh, that band sucks. That band sucks. Yeah. This is how I used to talk to my friends when we'd sit around and talk about music. That's how we talked about it. We didn't all just say, oh, I like that band too, even if I hated it. You know, we say, hey, I don't like that shit. You know, because we're friends. You know,
And you were honest with one another, and you don't wrap your soul up in it. Like somebody doesn't like the Beatles, I don't give a shit. Somebody doesn't like my Queen box set, I just start
that giggling. Queen box set sucks.
Yeah, that Queen box set sucks. Yeah.
That makes me laugh. But anyway, we had a great question today because it came from one of our new friends. We had to go through a rigid verification process.
It's good to see Deese again, though. That's nice.
Well, Deese has been here two days in a row. We need him more often. He showed us a great Beatle watch.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, this is totally doing a total Lennon. See, Rach, just check this out. I love the song, but it's very clear singer guitarist doing a total Lennon. You can tell when they put on the Beatles. Also, right on, Patrick, we argue for fun, not serious stuff. And it's friends. You're not trying to take the person down with it or crucify them for the love of God.
It's not like I'm insulting your mom or anything. It's just like, if I don't like a certain band or a certain song.
Anyway, now you had a bit of a health crisis yourself. You got through it all right and you're doing better now?
Oh, I just had some kind of flu thing, but yeah, I'm fine.
Everyone's getting that, Rachel.
Yeah. Oh, perhaps because I'm one of those unvaccinated, I seem just to be sailing through everything without a worry or a quibble. I simply wash my hands.
It just lasted a long time, longer than normal. I usually get sick, but I get over it really quick. But it took a while.
It does take a while to get over that one. I had lucked out for so long until December, finally got hit with it. Damn it. And it took like over a month before I finally felt normal. So
as normal as a Beatle fan can be, right?
Wow. There's that.
Okay. Yeah, but hold on. Patrick's a Beatles fan, too. Don't let him fool you.
I love the Beatles, yes.
Yes, you do. And Pretty Green Vinyl Guy, this is Edwin. Edwin, his Instagram is one of the best going, too. He does some advertising for his salon, his hair salon. And Sue, you actually attended the Pretty Green Vinyl Guy environs for your own hair doing. Yes. And you were thrilled. You just left it.
Yes. Now, Edwin didn't cut my hair, but
you weren't fortunate to get the head dog.
Well, I could have, but I would have had to wait like 2 months.
Yeah, he's very much in demand.
He's in demand.
Yes.
But I did get the best haircut I've ever had.
Yes.
Ever.
Let's call it a do.
A do.
Jen's here. Let's speak fluent girl. We've got a girl amongst us, so we can speak fluent female. So your do is just gorgeous. Yeah, just love what they did. And the highlights and everything are just so natural.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Beautiful. So,
I'm so glad I came up during hair care.
Sorry, Patrick. We'll get back.
I'll go back to the skull now.
Hey, Sue, I recommend you ask him to have your tips frosted.
What?
Holy crap. That is horrible. I'm due for a perm at Pretty Greens. Anyway, so he's not only he's a Beatle fan as well. And I was so fortunate, Patrick, you're going to love this comment. I bought maybe 10 or 11 Japanese Beatle pressings from Edwin for my own collection. The flag editions, the ones you've loved and championed on your own program, the Japanese with the flag on them, and you say, by gum, you'll be hard-pressed to get a better-sounding Beatles record than that one, Vinyl Community.
Why do you lie so much, Rachel? I mean, seriously.
I do it for comedic effect, obviously.
I'm starting to understand why Jimmy Barnes says the things he says.
Bob Jamme. Yes, I know. Awesome. Turn this stream into a hair stream. Earlier, JB was complaining about the same old, same old. Now we're into hairdoery. So this is fantastic.
Hairdoery, that's a word.
Hairdoery. And we were also going to backtrack.
Rachel making up words. That's another wonderful thing. Hairdoery.
It's all part of the Rachel lexicon. It's all good.
Exactly.
It's all good, and we're going full head with it, aren't we?
If you listen carefully, you can catch her on it, because she'll just blaze through it and just act like nothing happened. And then if you catch her on it, then she goes, oh, shit, yeah, okay.
It is bullshit, but, you know, but we have fun doing it.
Yes.
Now, Patrick, have you heard about the Jones Square Liam Gallagher record, and are you in any way excited about it? Or you said, I am giving this such a hard pass, I cannot tell you how hard passing I am on that.
I like the Gallagher brothers, but I haven't heard about it, no.
Oh, yeah. So you haven't heard the song or anything from the new album?
Is it better than the 106 song you shove down our throats every day?
Okay, hold on. Shoving down. Now, that is quickly soon to be released in our merch on an incredible 45. And Stunty has promised to bleed into the Dead Wax in order to have that as a moniker. So a little bit of Stunty will be pressed with each record.
I don't mean to cast aspersions, but Stunty doesn't have the greatest timeline track record in the vinyl community, just saying, you know.
Hi, Dr. Robert. Welcome to TV show. Dr. Robert, we had a great primary in Washington, D.C. Haley Mills coming strongly to the foreground.
Haley Mills, the actress?
I believe she's the young woman of Indian background that has been making a real...
Haley Mills, right?
Haley Mills. I was happy to see her. I as an alternative to Trump, I could accept Nikki Haley as our president.
President Haley.
She wouldn't be my top choice. But I'll tell you, the one thing she gets and she's called out is all of the noise on social media that is being created by our foreign competitors, if not enemies. That shouldn't be allowed. The free speech does not reach to non-citizens. And these are not...
Who's talking? Like, who's doing? Who's piping up?
Goodbye. Well,
hold on, Patrick. Don't go away. It's all hurt now.
Sorry. Let's not do politics right now.
Well, now Patrick's gone, and I wanted to hear you're in. I want to know who the foreigner speakers are. Is it the Canadians? Because a lot of Canadians are down in Arizona and Florida causing trouble with their Canadian waves. They're called snowbirds.
Yeah, my mom's a snowbird, but she goes. It's not
all right. Canadian. Look, PBTL doesn't do politics. I believe. And this is a full disclosure. Much like myself, PBTL is actually a castrati. So as a result of that, it's more about the music. Thank you, Patrick Miamlov. And also, Jasmine's mic speaks for so many when he says 106, 106, 106.
Scroozy's right, buzzkill. I'm guilty of buzzkill, so I'm changing the topic.
Okay, doctor. You talk about the love of music and... if you were ever held down, would you be able to say, here's my top three bands of all time?
You know, I could. It's hard, but I can tell you Dylan is number one. Golly. I mean, there's so many. I really loved The Who when I was in college, and I really loved The Clash. Those two were really high up there and still are. But, you know, people like Iggy Pop is big for me. I don't know. And how do you not like the Beatles and the Rolling Stones? Beatles were also a very early favorite. So, and Pink Floyd. I don't know. These are all classic. I feel like they're so, that's so cliche. They're all
But that's okay because it does. Not everybody's able to even answer the question. Like I go Beatles, yes, Led Zeppelin, 1, 2, and 3, like that. And then closely in there is Pink Floyd coming up, you know, 3rd, 4th kind of thing. I love Pink Floyd, David Bowie, and you can tell by how many records you got. XTC, I got everything, all their studio albums.
Yeah, I like them.
Weezer, for the love of God, I got every Weezer album, studio album going. Yeah. So I like all that stuff. And the Beatles is just overdosed. They're the one band I actually collect. Like, I don't consider myself a collector of the other stuff. I'm not collecting for the sake of collecting. I just, I like the album. I want the music. I'm buying it. But Beatles, I go, well, I've already got the music. What in God's green earth do you want that? Well, I'm a collector of it. So I'm going to have this, got a different cover. I'm going to get this. So I got a lot of redundancy when it comes to my Beatles. When you think about it, the band only did, what, 13 albums? You know, and this is all Beatles.
Yeah.
It's just crazy. And that's not counting all the box sets that are floating around.
Right.
Stones top too. Boom. Yeah, Stones are great too. They're still a top 10 band for me.
They are.
Rolling Stones top 10.
Yeah. So you know that bit on that Saturday Night Live did on who's on first, and they got Yes on there too. It's a takeoff of the Abbott and Costello thing.
Yeah, the old stand up. Yeah,
it's so
funny. Don't know. Who's on first? I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. No, I'm telling you who.
Yeah.
And then they borrowed the joke again on Animaniacs for Slappy Squirrel on their Woodstock episode.
I have to look for that.
Yeah. Henry Lemoyne, new member to the show, Beatles Queen top two. I'll tell you about Queen. What's great about Queen, they had an original sound. So often when you're hearing bands and stuff, when it becomes whitewashed and cookie-cuttered, everything sounds the same. You don't even know who you're listening to. Like New Country got that way very quickly. Unless you knew the artist.
Your sound.
Yeah, right.
Rachel.
Sound like you fell down a well.
Uh-oh.
Oh, now it's back. Okay.
Oh.
But don't repeat yourself, please.
Oh. And we had a glitch there, so. Okay, so anyway, so Queen is great because they had such a unique sound. Freddie, different vocals, that operatic influence that was so great in their stuff. A lot of fun, very dramatic, great presentation. My first song that I ever owned from them was Killer Queen. Am I still in the fish tank?
No, you're good.
No.
Oh.
It was literally like maybe 20 seconds that sounded like that.
I know the parents of the girl, Jessica, that fell down the well. Tell them we say hello.
I'm a firm believer we only all have 8 stories. Patrick has said that before.
Okay, there was an Animaniacs reference by Beetle Babe.
Yes.
Congratulations, okay. Nathaniel, for pointing that out.
Nathaniel knows it, though. Yeah, but Nathaniel.
Yes. It's hard to believe that Nathaniel watches cartoons all day.
Sometimes watch a show is like visiting the old folks home on Bridge Day when they're all reminiscing about the old days and their senility.
Hold on, ADK. That's a very specific reference.
Yeah.
Very specific.
Yes. Oh. Okay, something happened with David yesterday in the OR. Doctor, you're used to this kind of situation. You're a good-looking fella. Can you make this comment? This is Dr. Robert, real doctor, just like we got Jen, a real girl. We got a real doctor, not a made-up kind of doctor, you know, like Dr. Octopus or something from Spider-Man. Go ahead, Doc, read this one.
You want me to read that?
Yeah, you have to read it out loud for all the children.
Oh, good God. So,
thank you for your enthusiasm, Dr. Robert.
Yeah, right. Thank you for this assignment, Rachel. So, Dr. Robert, my wife's here, so I'll read it to her. I was in an operating theater yesterday.
Yes.
The surgeon was like George Clooney to the max, and the three nurses were hotter than the sun. Is this normal?
Yes, good question. It's a medical question.
I'm going to let my wife answer that one.
Okay. So they've got his doctor. Right.
Just so people know, your wife was a surgeon too, right?
Yes.
Exactly.
She doesn't look like George Clooney.
She looks like, hold on, she looks like a very pretty doctor nurse. Okay, so here we go. Look at this. George Clooney is the doctor, and three hotter nurses that are even hotter than the sun. They're so hot. Doctor wife, what do you think about this event? Is it typical in the... I know you folks are absolutely gorgeous couple. So good looks do come with the medical profession.
You're covered with your nose is covered, your head's covered. How can you tell who's attractive? Well,
yeah, everybody's wearing masks.
As someone who's been operated on, Rachel.
Yes. And as someone who failed medical college, go ahead, Rob.
But Rachel, I mean David, how high were you?
Yeah,
I was gonna say the same thing. I was gonna say how good were the pain meds they were giving you?
How jacked up exactly on drugs were you
he may have been in an alternate reality there.
Okay, now this is very Jewish humor from Israel. Can you read this? Look at what he says. It's a play on words, and you guys see what he's done with it.
Norman Maslow, look, a paradox. Get it?
You see, it's a pair of doctors.
Oh,
hey, what a boom. Deese, this is what you should say to Mazzy.
Yeah.
You could be shot for a comment like that in my country. Yeah.
Has the Dark Lord arrived?
Paradox.
Hi, Dark Lord. Okay, Queen's music is insanely timeless. We will rock you, always used in sporting events. Bohemian Rhapsody, widely considered great. It's the only old band that has the most Spotify listeners. Well, they are great, and they did so many great songs, and they weren't a one-trick pony. That was hit after hit after hit, and the band changed and evolved. They could do ballads. They could do very theatrical tunes, and they could straight out rock and roll. They were an incredible band, and Queen is a top 10 band for me.
I will say this about Queen, Rachel, and you could probably say at least two or three times in the last 30 years, they've had a sort of resurrection of their albums or whatever.
Yes.
Because I thought like in the 90s, Disney bought their catalog, right?
Yeah.
And that kind of resurrected their catalog.
Yeah.
And then that movie kind of resurrected.
It did. It was a shot in the arm for them. There's no doubt. No, Saba, I can probably do a top 10 for you. That would be really easy. I love this comment. Now, Doctor, you're familiar with, what do they call it? Animal husbandry or comfort animals in medical profession. Henry Lebois, he says, I got all four of my wisdom teeth taken a couple of weeks ago. I was in so much pain. The first 2 days, they gave him a parakeet to calm him down and make him comfort him. I think this is incredible. It's showing it's a more holistic approach to medicine. Congratulations, Henry.
Hold on. Yeah, I believe they gave you so much drugs, you thought you saw a parakeet.
I
think he bit the head off the parakeet, and that's what gave him the pain relief. And the parakeet was full of Percocet.
There you go.
Okay. We got an issue here with the Dark Lord. Deese, again, I turn to you for this. Take a drink and then read the. It's something about the Dark Lord.
The Dark Lord says, Rich Rice Paddies Jr., I work nights now.
Okay, he's a night owl working the night shift. Now, I'll let Jen finish drinking. We're going to go to Jen with our next question. Jen, have you ever had a night shift? You ever did any kind of employment that required a night shift?
I worked in a pizza place that did, and it sucked.
Okay. So a lot of pizza would be purchased after, like, 3 o'clock. Pizza.
Oh, God, yes. Pretty much around 4 o'clock is when it picks up and does not slow down till about 9 or 10, at least, sometimes later.
Now, from what I understand, you got out of the pizza game?
Yeah, I was only in that for, like, 2 years.
2 years of pizza service. Mm-hmm. Rob, you've often tried to get into the pizza game yourself. But you had developed an allergy to anchovies?
Oh, no, not the anchovies.
Yeah. Very sensitive stomach. And Dr. Robert and I have talked about this. They actually resulted in some sort of polyp development in the nether region.
Oh, no.
Rachel, is it true the only related pizza story you've told me is back when Domino's had that 30-minute guarantee?
30
you
minutes.
Desperately tried to get free pizzas.
I did. They said it was in the contract.
I flipped pizzas for a while.
Okay. Now, do you prefer flipping pizzas or flipping spines?
No, it was not even close.
Yeah, it's a different game, isn't it? Same people, but different game.
Yeah, it was just a money making gig.
Now the people bitch more in the pizza one.
Yes, right.
Okay, we got a question here that we don't have any of our Seattle people here. Dr. Robert is in Oregon. I don't believe you made the trip north for the Seattle show.
Oh, no, I did. So I was,
okay.
I came up I came up, well, we needed to come up here anyway, but so we came up, we're headed back to Portland today. So this is my Seattle spot. There's my, let's see.
Okay.
There you go. That's the Esquire photo of the Jazz people.
Oh, yeah, we know that picture. Remember, we went to the music store, and that's the picture they had.
Yeah.
See that too?
That's the spontaneous. It's everybody that was just hanging. It's got Monk and I don't know. It's just got so many people in it.
We were in Victoria, and a guy there has a copy of that photograph. It's basically a who's who of the jazz scene at that time. And it's a veritable who's who of everybody that you want to have. Right.
Mingus is Miles is not in it, and Parker had died, so he wasn't in it. But
okay, Jim says no anchovies, please. It's a great tune by Jay Giles. Anyone with me? No, slinks away. Jim, Jay Giles is another great band. Peter Wolf was kind of a very much in the vein, pardon the pun, of Mick Jagger. People, the comparisons were made. Me too, says AGK. I made pizza at Mom's Pizza Pop Shop in the 80s for about a year. Is Mom owned a Pizza Pop Shop? What do you think about that, Deese? Would you like to own a Pizza Pop Shop?
I'd like to go back to the 80s and eat pizza, yeah.
Okay, an 80s pizza.
Hold on, Rachel, hold on.
Go ahead, Rob. Opportunity.
Just like a Cracker Jack, John Bip Bop Boom made a comment.
Yeah.
I was the recipient of a pizza box from Rachel.
Yes.
There was pepperoni stains on the record she sent me.
Okay, now that's only, you know, but the, as a means of protecting your records and pizza box, if they'll...
I had somebody send me records in a pizza box once, actually.
Yeah, it's well-established principle.
There was even grated Parmesan cheese and hot pepper flakes in there, too.
Okay, Sue has it. The producer says, I worked at Romeo's Pizza a very long... Well, you're so much younger than me, but you're getting up in years now. Dr. Robert, you have a record you'd like to show the children?
Well, I thought I'd show a few. So several people on the Peanut Gallery were asking about the record show. And I was there. Mazzy was there. Mark Wald and his wife, Elise, were selling there. And Kimbo was there. The funny part is Kimbo and I were going to go visit another record collector afterwards. We had lunch with Mazzy, and then we were leaving at about noon. And my he gave me a ride to my car, and my phone fell out in his car, and I couldn't find it. And so it became like a two-hour enterprise calling my phone and then calling him and going back to everywhere I was. So that was a lot of fun yesterday, but Kimbo was very patient and helped me get the phone back, and Mark and Elise were very helpful in placing several calls to my phone and his phone. So that's a different story, but I found this is second pressing. The original pressing of this is worth like $400, but this one's not worth nearly that, but it's nice to get it. It's one I didn't have in my collection. Nice Northwest.
Yeah, Paul Revere,
Paul Revere and the Raiders. This is a really cool record that I was not aware of. And actually, I inherited this. I bought it off of Mazzy on Saturday at the Dizzy record sale or auction online. And Wax was there. You guys might have talked about it yesterday. I don't know that sale. But that went very well. Every record sold, and some very good stuff was passed along. And this was one I scored there. I'd never heard of this. It's a kind of psych jazz. And it's got, I didn't realize it at the time that I bought it. It's got Michael White on violin, who's one of my favorites as a jazz violin player.
It's not a promo, is it? It's a white label.
It's not. It looks like it. It's a white label, but that's just the
way it came out.
Yeah. And then this was one I found yesterday.
A big album.
Oh my God. I mean, this has the creator has a master plan sung by Leon Thomas. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know.
If you guys know label, nice.
Oh, he is so good. Yeah, that's an original. And
the thing about this, I've been tempted to pick it up. Sue, Rob, my guru, my jazz guru, Rob looked at me and says, that will make Sue's eyes melt. Stay away from that particular album. It's too heavy. It's too jazz. It's too deep for Sue as an ingenue with her jazz accoutrements. So we've got her on Dave Brubeck, a heavy diet of Dave Brubeck to keep everything.
Dave Brubeck is safe. I like Brubeck, but
yeah, he's my favorite. I love him.
Yeah, I will say one more thing. I listened to this yesterday, and I hadn't ever put it together. But the creator has a master plan, stretches from first side to second side. That is kind of a reboot of A Love Supreme. It's got the rhythm of A Love Supreme running through it. It's there. So that's very cool. Anybody want to confirm that or deny that? But that's the way it sounded to me, which was really a revelation.
Okay. Don't time out the cat. We're going to get the cat. Piccolo. Hang on, Bocalina. At his mother, we give her a ranch. Bocalina, I assume it's a girl cat. Anyway, welcome, girl cat, real person. Okay, here we go, Trogs. Here we go.
Last one. So this is the Trogs Wild Thing album, but you can see it's a French pressing, Les Trogs.
Yeah,
Les Trogs. Yeah, just kind of fun. I have an American, actually a couple of American copies of this with different covers, but
yeah.
So scored some stuff, had a lot of fun with the Mazzy and Kimbo and Mark and Elise, and I'm sorry.
Yeah, group of people, Doc. Very
it
nice.
Really group was. It really was. And a lot of the sellers, Mike Samples, I'll call out. He's the one who always runs this show up here, and I've known him just from buying off his table some of my favorite records. He's always got great stuff. So
somebody else knows a thing or two about jazz. Dr. Rob, check out Louis Armstrong's version of The Creator Has a Master Plan. It's really cool.
Is that a real thing? I hadn't been aware.
Rob?
What album is that on?
What album is it on, Mark? Okay. And Bill K is trying to explain. Piccolina, welcome to our TV show. You've got a wrench now. You'll never be timed out again, dear.
Yeah, until you reveal who you really are.
No, Piccolina's cool. I know her from Joe Mayo's channel too. She's cool.
A girl, just leave her. She's a real girl too, like Jen. Okay, it's fantastic.
Oh, hold on, Rachel.
Oh, what's happened with Deesa? Got dark over there. Go ahead, Rob.
Well, no, I found the thing. I'm gonna put it in the comments. What Lastman was talking about. There you go. That's the Louis Armstrong doing the album.
Louis Armstrong and his friends. It's an interesting album. Here's a link to it, Vinyl Community.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Waxed. I'll check it out.
Piccolina, Sue loves your cat. Sue's a real girl, too. Sue, can you say hi to Piccolina?
Hi, Piccolina.
That's Sue.
Meow.
Yeah. Jen, can you say hi to Piccolina?
Hi, Piccolina.
Rob, can you say hi to Piccolina?
Meow.
Oh, that you're working it. Mm-hmm. I have not seen a fellow work a gal that way since I've seen Renee work in Beetle Babe.
Should I put on the cat headphones for Piccolina?
Oh, no, that's too cute. Look at that. I want that.
I got it on Amazon. They sell them cheap. They got them in different colors.
I get pink. That is
you
so
could get pink. I almost got pink, but then I was like, wait, there's weird ramifications, and someone will say it first chance they get. So I was like, maybe
Rachel.
Yes, go ahead, Rob.
The stream's becoming very yeasty right now.
Oh, look at this, Rob. It's simping hard. That's just crazy stuff. Now, folks, earlier in the show, we had Dee showing us a new release from Seiko Corporation. It's the exclusive Beatles Hard Day's Night watch. The details are all there.
Does it cost for that watch?
Dee's still don't know. No, it's still no price. It's an Italian forum, so I don't know yet, but it'd probably be quite
would you think? What do you think? Would you think like 2,000? Is that too much? What do you
think? That's me, yeah.
1,500 maybe.
Okay, I love this. Is this an LGBTQ QWERTY, a charity stream? It could be some. Yeah, it could be QWERTY. Okay, Sue, Jim has got a recommendation for you, Jazz. And Rob, I want you to tune in on this. Let me know. Use your jazz, put your jazz mind together. I recommend Very Tall by the Oscar Peterson Trio, Milt Jackson. Fantastic with kicks, but still can wrap your toe to it. Chad did a recent reissue. This sounds fantastic, Chaddy Cox.
Hey, so, yeah. Sue, do you have issues with the vibraphone?
No.
All right, then you should like that.
Okay. Hi, Piccolina Cat. Dr. Robert, are you fond of cats to any extent?
Yeah, we have a cat and okay. A cat and a dog. We love animals. My wife loves animals. Susan loves animals too. So
that's my sister. Yeah. She's a horsey girl. She loves dogs. But it's so addictive because you get on the Insta, you come in for your music friends, and then suddenly, because Sue likes dogs, a doggy thing will come up, and so you like. Next thing you know, I'm getting tons of doggies. Ago, I like that one. And now I see doggies as many times as I see records.
Yeah, that happened to me too with Instagram, to where pretty quickly the entire recommended for you page just became nothing but Pomeranians. And I am not complaining about that, but I'm just like, oh, wow, it knows me well. Okay.
Okay, hold on, best friends gang. You must choose cat or dog. No, it's not an either or. You can love all the animals.
You can, and I do.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh. Do you guys hear of the jazz blues singer Lucille Bogan? She has one of the filthiest songs I've ever heard from the 20s. Yeah, we know who she is. And you know who discovered her is somebody was showing, talking about her music. She's a blues singer. And it was Macamania. Richard Dolan picked up on that.
Really?
And oh, he was so enamored of her. Because she does sexy, naughty songs. But yeah, so that's the whole thing. Cats do go in the house, but you have a litter box for that, okay? And then you just have a little
smidge. Little dogs go in the house too?
Yeah, little dog. Well, if you have a little spot for them. We always took ours out. We have a little. We had a little guy.
I was trained to go in the shower, so.
Holy smokes, we're going to run this thing for a 3.5 hour blockbuster spectacular. We're going to go 3.5 hours, 10 more minutes. Let's get all our record questions in. You want to know about record cleaning? Deese is here to help you with that. We have an expert in each category. Beetle Babe's here to talk to you about outer sleeves and inner sleeves, which ones to use, which ones to avoid. Rob is here to talk to you about his extensive monkeys collection. And Dr. Robert, of course, our go-to Beatles expert. And of course, I'm here for all your avant-garde noise and experimental electronic questions.
I thought that was going to be the monkey's expert.
Okay. Dr. Winston Boogie, this is Barry out in Newcastle, England. He writes, complete vinyl collection gone. My new streaming system is up and running. It sounds superb. Rob, counter this because you went the opposite way. You started, but here's a veteran.
Well, okay. Here's the deal. I consider Barry a very sweet, nice person.
Yes, very.
But sweet. He has a dark side, and what I mean by dark side is you had some sort of connection to the OBC.
Yes.
So now, what did you do with your OBC card, Barry?
Okay, really good. Great question here. A great comment from Patrick Sweden. All topics are covered on this live stream every day. And Saba writes, if only Renee was here for a bit of inner and outer sleeve talk. So that's a great comment coming from Samava Dimitrov. Question, monkey's question. Okay, this will be for Rob. Was the Nesmith hat...
I know this.
Was that a mandate from the label to wear the little woolen cap?
You know, here, Rachel, I have an issue with Best Friends Gang.
Okay, what's your issue with Best Friends Gang?
Every time I see Best Friends Gang, the word bang is added to his name.
West Gang, Friends Gang?
Yes.
Holy smoke. Okay, Jack, do you want to try this? All right, here we go.
So actually, that hat his grandmother made for him. And he wore it to the screen test, and then they just made it become a part of the show. But the original one, that was his.
Yes. Thank you so much for that, Chen. So it's his. Now, speaking of the monkeys, everyone should know Neil Diamond wrote I'm a Believer. He gets credit for that. Well, we all know that. Everybody should know it.
Hey, hold on. Henry, it seems like you have a copy of the Trivial Pursuit game right next to you. While you...
Oh, that's
basically, he Googles shit and he tries to sound smarter than you.
Everybody knows. Are you
taking in the question from Trivial Pursuit?
That's such a good idea.
Okay, hold on. Look at this. Did Rachel just call me Smava? You're Sava. I didn't call you Smava. Well, I could have. But I wouldn't mean it. I call you Sava with great respect and love. Okay, Rachel needs a topic timer. Like, pardon the interruption on ESPN. Holy smokes. Yeah, you just go every 15 seconds. Rapid fire. Boom. A little bit me, a little bit you. Also by the Monkees, Neil Diamond. Again, another hit. Okay, anyone into Van de Graaff Generator? It's Prague. I like Prague. Go ahead, Doctor.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Van de Graaff Generator. I came across one of the records that was a repress I got when I was years ago in college, and I've tracked down I think just about all of their stuff since. But really good. I'm blanking on who's their lead singer. He's Peter Hamill. Man, he's got really an operatic voice, I would call it, a really great voice and unique as a pop or rock singer. And he's put out a ton of solo stuff that's also really good stuff.
Beetle Babe, I once took an IQ test. I scored 133.
Okay.
Henry, he's a bright spark. Doctor, have you ever had an IQ test? It's how you'd think something they'd want to do for a spinal surgeon. They wouldn't want to compete buffoon or a moron, an absolute mentally incompetent, go in there with the delicate nerve endings of such a delicate part of the human anatomy.
Oh, I think I did years ago, but I honestly don't even remember the score.
Will Rachel's Beatles Wikipedia? Listen, Sava, or is it Smava? If you keep saying stuff like that, I don't use the Wikipedia. For when I talk Beatles, I've got an encyclopedic knowledge of the Fab Four. Unbelievable. My buddies and I, in the 70s, we used to have trivia games where we try and stump each other on Beatle questions and stuff. I once took a math test. I did fail it. I would love to come. Rob, amongst a best friend's gang with a comment for Waxed. Rob, are you trying to speed date somebody on there? What's going on? You're very involved.
Well, you know, my proclivities are my own, Rachel.
Okay, look at this.
We call our fans gangbangers. Would love to count Rob one of them.
All right.
No, thank you.
Jess, you're very polite. No, go ahead, Dr. Robert.
I wanted to ask Waxed, have you already talked about the Dizzy auction?
Okay.
Well, that time you said... that you kept correcting me through the whole.
Mostly it was confirming that you were right.
Ultimately, hey, proven correct.
Oh, hold on, Rachel. I just, if anyone's a member of Vinyl Me Please, they're reissuing. I don't even know if it was ever on vinyl, but this record is fan fucking tastic.
Yes.
This is the best five first album.
Yeah, I like them. Yeah. I like them.
They're issuing this on vinyl, and I'm going to order a copy because it is a great album.
They remind Ben Folds Five. They always reminded me of Ben Dudley and The Range. Remember them or whatever that group was, The Range?
No, you're talking about Listen to the Mandolin Rain. Is that what you're talking about?
Hans Mulgrave and The Range. Something like it was something in The Range. That's all I remember.
Hey, so can you water Rachel? It seems like she's becoming a little...
I'm a little dehydrated. Dr. Robert has great taste in headwear. Let's see what you're...
There you go.
Okay, is that Jupiter, Florida?
Yeah, that's the St. Louis Cardinals spring training stadium.
Hold on. Barry, I don't know what you're referencing there, Barry.
Okay.
Hey, there. Can you show the one from Hate Street Voice there?
Yeah, who's the Hate Street Voice? Looks like a friend.
Yes, I'm hoping to invite her on. Maybe the next, if she wants to come. Her name is Linda Kelly, and she edits and puts together this newsletter from Hate Street.
Okay,
my wife and I ran into her there a couple weeks back, and she's a real music person, and I think she'd really enjoy. So I asked her to come watch today. So to see you, Linda.
And, Hi, Linda. Yeah, we'd be very interested in hearing, especially Hate. Haight Street in San Francisco. Here's the interesting thing about that. I once visited San Francisco. I've been a couple of times, but I've never been able to get down to Haight because I was with local San Franciscans, and they said, you don't want to go down there. There's nothing there. I go, yeah, but it's Haight and Ashbury. I want to go to Ashbury, Haight and Ashbury. They go, no, there's nothing there. So that was
still all kinds of stuff. There's not anything there, but at the same time, I get the appeal. I'm like, I would bring you there just so you could say you've seen it. Because, yeah, even if somebody lives near it, I had that same moment of, I want to see it just for the sake of seeing it. And yeah, I can attest there really isn't much of anything there. But at the same time, I can say that I've seen it. I've seen that sign. So there is that.
Okay. I've got Josh's best friend gang. Best friend's gang is on as Josh's. Hi, Josh. Now, you're a friend of Rob's? Oh, then we can't hear you, Josh. There's something vocally we're not able to hear. Josh, we're getting nothing.
You're So there's Linda saying she saw her first show was the Sex Pistols. So she and Mazzy overlapped, and
Mazzy was there.
Yeah,
Mazzy says it was a horrible show, but it's one of the things he was so happy just to have been there. Okay, Josh, try again.
Can you hear me now?
We hear you, Josh. Yeah. Welcome Beautiful. To the show. Welcome. Hi. How are you doing?
I'm doing really well. How about y'all?
That's great. Do you want to tell? Do you have a channel yourself and do stuff?
Yeah, I have a channel. It's called Best Friends Gang.
Okay, what do you do on the Best Friends Gang show?
Review old records and make mini documentaries.
Okay, let me make sure I'm subscribed to you.
I think you are. I think you watched my Style Council video for a little bit.
Okay, I would have done so. Anyway, well, welcome to this show. And tell the kids what they're going to find over on your show and what you like bands and stuff. We'll promote you and we'll make sure we get a link to your channel. So I'll get that going.
Yeah, I'm a former concert and music reviewer for like music papers in New Jersey and Pennsylvania.
Okay, so you're on the East Coast.
Yeah.
Okay.
I also lived in Atlanta for like 12 years.
Oh, okay. Atlanta, Georgia. So a little bit of Southern flavor, the North. So you got both things working there.
I got it all working, Rachel.
All right. Well, so I'm happy to have you. Have I had you up before?
I don't think I've been on the channel before, no.
Okay. Well, welcome.
First time, long time.
Here you are. Yeah, I'm subscribed. You have got 588 subscribers so far. So now that I'm there, I can give you a link and show the kids a picture of your screen and everything. And Doctor, your friend is from Haight Street Voice. What your friend's name is?
It's Linda.
Linda.
Linda Kelly. Linda Kelly.
Linda Kelly. Okay. Well, I'll just use her first name. So it's Linda Haight Street Voice. When I see her, I'll be able to know that it's Linda. I'll put her in my book of words. In the meantime, Josh, tell us about your channel, what you're working on.
So I haven't touched the channel a little bit, but most of it is just reviews of old records and then working on another documentary now on my life with the Thrill Kill Cult.
Okay, what's that entail?
It's an industrial band from like the late 80s, early 90s. I think they're still going today. But kind of like an early advocate of LGBTQ stuff.
Okay, and then I got to go. Best Friends Gang is Josh. I got to put you in my thing. Oh, I've already got you down. Best Friends Gang.
There you go. Subscribe now. You have 591.
Okay, so you got another subscriber. This is what we want. Best Friends Gang. Up here is the link. And Linda, if you have a channel, we'll promote your channel here as well. Get people drive traffic to you. This is a great stream for that. We love promoting channels and doing things. We'll stay a little longer because Josh just joined us. Don't be a stranger, Josh. You can come up anytime you want and talk about
whatever you want
to do. You know, it's an open door around here, right? Yeah. Okay. The channel is Haight Street Voice. Let me go get my book of words for that. But before I do that, I'll just show you Josh's channel, the lay of the land. So when you get there, you know you're at the right place. Okay. Probably the best band in the world. The Style Council. Oh, that was very good. I think that's how I found you. 3 years ago, videos. Let's go. 9 months ago. So about 9 months ago is the last time you were busy. Nelson. Jazz Funk Fusion, Zoe Johnson, Moon Shadows, Country Music Queen, Pennsylvania, Dutch Funnel Cakes. So we got some stuff off the beaten path here.
I like novelty records.
That would be good. Music is Jimmy Swagger, Oh, I've Sinned, the famous I've Sinned pitcher. And then a week later, he's back on the strip trying to pick up prostitutes. Crazy. Last recordings of the Jam, Rob Walker. I hope you're listening. This is what I discovered you, and I must have subbed you up when I saw that. Anyway, well, this is really great. 594 subscribers. I think we need to get more for you. 13 videos. We need to updo your, you know, your output and get more content.
I'm working on it.
Yeah, it's not easy, right? It's easy for me to say. Okay, there is an interview with Bob Weir, the Grateful Dead, if you like that hippie stuff. Many, many people do. I've got about 4 Grateful Dead albums in my own collection. I'm not the biggest Deadhead around, but, you know, obviously I'm familiar with the band. And it was great. Yeah, so much coming out of San Francisco. Jefferson Airplane, famously one of the big ones. Scott McKenzie, are you going to San Francisco with flowers in your hair? Be sure to wear some flowers in your hair. So, I mean, San Francisco, what a sight. Oh, the Bo Brummels, San Francisco. Are you kidding me? Holy smokes. So many great bands. Pardon me, Beetle Babe. You're from the Bay Area. I didn't realize
the Bo Brummels were San Francisco.
We are San Francisco. And in fact, on, I forget the name of the album, but there's a picture of either the Bay Bridge or the Golden State. We talked about that the other day. Flamin' Groovies. What is the worst Grateful Dead record? I'm not an expert on the Dead. So
well, Mazzy doesn't like that disco one where they're all dressed in white suits.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And
go, go to heaven.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Say it again.
Rachel, I have to go.
Deese, I saw you on the phone. If you do run across Malachi, send him my love, please.
I'm meeting him, so I'll send him your love.
Yes.
You want to have a great day. Nice meeting you, people I have never met. And
yes. Nice come days. Back. Come back soon, Deese. We love you.
Bye. Shalom.
Okay. Now, spring 2024 edition of my magazine cover story is going to be Flamin' Groovies.
Right.
All right. So now, Linda runs the magazine. Is that what's happening, Dr. Hart?
That's right. She doesn't have an online, I don't think. And I'll let, but I just talked to her later this week, maybe tomorrow. Yeah. She can get on and kind of describe her own stuff. So,
yeah, we start awfully early, Linda. If you're not a morning person, and most women I know are not morning people.
I am.
Are you a morning girl? That's yep. Really good.
But then I go to bed super early, so it all evens out.
You are going to do great here. I am the magazine. Okay. It's HateStreetVoice.com. Head over there, folks. I know I'll be groggy. Groggy is okay. Just, I don't know if you do coffee at all, but we'll get Mazzy over there. If you come up, we can do it with Jen here. Rob's down in LA.
Yeah.
And but we could do a, you know, like a Los Angeles, San Francisco, but spectacular where we talk cool. About the music scene.
Yeah, hey, there's a Rachel, there's a dumpster behind the 7-Eleven we can all meet at.
That sounds like a David Lynch scene. Isn't that crazy? Mulholland Drive where the little, the hobo, homeless fella
comes. There's some syringes on the ground and used rubbers. It's good.
Are you going to San Fernando? But anyway, it's just crazy. Be sure to wear some needles in your arm. I'm just joking, YouTube. Don't take it seriously. Oh, all right. Well, listen, folks, we've been here 3 hours, 36 minutes. Josh, we put a link for you there. We got to get HateStreetVoice.com just to get her channel name. So we'll promote while she's here. Hate Street Voice. Hate Street Voice. Boom. There she is. Hi. Oh, she's got the music right away when you go in there. She's got a great thing. The Wizard of Oz with Hate Street Voice. Psychedelic record right there.
Rachel, am I wrong about this? But yeah, have you gone up 300% in the female lady people that come here?
I don't know. We're drawing a larger group of gals. Young Lisa's here. Okay, listen. Here's the link. Hate Street Voice. And just as I did to show you with Josh, I'll show you what her page looks like so you know you've arrived at the right destination. All this present, share screen. Hate Street Voice, boom. There, and this is the important part here, kids. Let me go right to the page over here. Make sure you're subscribed. So I'm your 507th. That should read seven. So I just gave you a nice sub. Bob Weir, Billy Strings. Billy String has got, I learned about him from Elliot Cruz. Billy Strings has got a lot of street cred. Billy Strings does a lot of bluegrass-inspired stuff, folksy stuff. Bob Weir, part one, of course, the legend that is Bob Weir. The great documentary, the other one that was on Netflix with Bob Weir. Very good story. Talks about, because something resonated with me. I'm adopted. Bob Weir was adopted, and he found his biological family. Very interesting documentary and about the Grateful Dead and what it was all about. Okay, and so she's got different events. China Kantner, of course. Well, that should China Kantner Eisler. That name Kantner should ring some bells for people, musical bells. So a lot of good content. Hanging at Fire Station 12 in the Hate, seeing the local folks. Color of Love, healing through tie dye. Boy, is that needed! Tie dye is a great art. We have a little show. I have some tie dye myself up here. But what a time! What an experience! What a great place to be from. To call San Francisco your hometown, you're doing pretty good. So, Josh, I'm so glad you came up. Now, were you happy with today's show? Did we cover some of the bases that you like? Do we need to get a little more out there with some sort of crazy, off-the-beaten-path kind of music you like? Or what? How are we doing?
It should just be Beatles 24/7.
Beatles 24/7. Well, obviously, I would agree, but... we have such a wide fan base. There's no way we can sustain that. They would.
No, let's get out there. Revolt. Let's get out there.
Holy smoke. They would revolt, but we're going to take it. Well, I want to thank all my guests. Jen, of course, the incredible Dr. Robert. Doctor, it hurts when I do this.
Don't do that.
Oh, thank you, doctor. That'll be $500. All right. And then, Josh, can we look forward to your return sooner than later?
I'll return.
All right, that's what we like there. We will, because you've got a Louis Golden dulceted calm demeanor that is required for the program.
I don't think he knows who that is, Rachel.
I think he knows. Well,
Louis, okay.
All right, so Linda, let's get you back. Let's get you up on camera. We'll talk about your magazine, how it started, how it got going. Richard, you always ask for a link at the end of the TV show. I think it's strategically planned. Thank you, everybody. Please like the video. It does help with the algorithms. Josh, Doc, Rob, Jen, we'll see you tomorrow, hopefully. All right. Bye for now.
Cheers, everybody.
Bye, everybody.
Cheers.